Good afternoon. It's the last full day of drama in Doha with the last five events to come in the individual apparatus finals. Now, since 2003, Great Britain's gymnasts have never failed to win a medal at these World Gymnastics Championships. And that's very much due to the efforts of people like this. Beth Tweddle, Christian Thomas, welcome to you both. In fact, if you were to put your combined hardware from Olympics, World, European and Commonwealth Games on the table, it would probably collapse. But we're glad to have you with us today. And you're happy to watch others do the work at the moment and continue the success. And that's exactly what Max Whitlock did yesterday. Now, OK, his seventh World Championship medal was not the colour he'd been looking for on pommel horse. He had been going for a third gold in a row. But after being given exactly the same score as China's Zhao Ruoteng, to the thousandth of a point, Max lost out to Zhao's superior execution score and he had to settle for silver. But Britain's Rio Olympic champion is still very much in the shake-up then as we head towards Tokyo 2020. Now, there is one more British gymnast to follow today, and he's a 23-year-old Brummy, Dom Cunningham. Now, what a breakthrough year it's been for him. Medals at the Commonwealths and the Europeans. Now he's in a world final in the vault. And that really is a poke in the eye to everyone who once questioned, made fun of his passion for this sport.
Dominic Cunningham from the City of Birmingham Gymnastics Club.
To have that title against my name for the rest of my life now, European champion, there's not many people who can say that, and I'm one of them.
Super control, these big tumbles.
I knew I could do it.
Big triple twist to finish, what a performance!
Dominic Cunningham rising to the challenge!
When my score went high, I was just like, I think I dropped to the floor. I don't even remember so much what I did, I just dropped to the floor. I was just like, goosebumps. Hearing the national anthem, I was just like, jeez! It was a madness. It was just, it's what I live for, and I want more moments like that. At the end of last year, pretty much ready to retire, or I was like, this is so hard to keep going. I was always battling for to making the teams, but I always just missed out on the team. I was always the seventh person. I was like, this is too hard to keep doing that. Luckily, I turned around and I was like, right, let's do it. I had 5 weeks off and I came back with the most amount of fire inside me. And I was like, yeah, let's go. I set out my targets, Commonwealth Games, European Championships and World Championships. With my training now, where there is happiness, there is success, and that's what I've been trying. Growing up, it was tough, and it's so easy to break a person. There has been times where not scared of someone, but I was always scared of what they'd say in front of other people, and it's so easy for people to latch on. Oh, that's the girl gymnast. You don't want to get grouped up onto, and that's where it started to go. I remember there was one time my mum took me to school, and I just hid in the footwell of the car with a blanket over me because I didn't want to go. I'm only about 9, 10 years old at this time, and I'm like not wanting to go to school because of what people were calling me names because of what sport I did. But then the whole thing changes because when I'm walking around on my hands and everyone's like, whoa, that's so cool. For a tip for anyone who might still go through those gymnastics like comments, just remember who you're doing it for. When they've got not the best job, you can do handstand backflips for your country. So yeah, just don't listen to people, listen to yourself. I'm out there to bring back medals. It's my first World Championships. I'm going to be in the deep end, but I'm going to show through that this little Dominic Cunningham, great British gymnast, I'm coming through with fire. Europe was a big competition, but the world, we're talking the next level now. So I'm looking forward to it. Bring it on! I'm on it!
Well, he is a man on a mission. Dominic Cunningham prowling at the end of this 25-metre runway for his first vault in the final here at his very first World Championships. He is a man who has lots to achieve, Craig Heap. He's got a great deal of confidence and he qualified fifth for this vault final. Got to hold it together now and show everybody what he can do.
Yep, yeah, big talent. European champion on floor, unlucky not to make the vault final as well. But really must hold his nerve now in this big field. Starts well, wraps in, the double twist on the straight front. That's what Biles does or tries to do in her competition. It's such a difficult vault. He opts for the round off, half turn onto the vault, into the handspring straight front with a double twist. 5.4 on difficulty, so that's a maximum he can score of 15.4.
Well, just to explain how the vaults competition works, each gymnast does two vaults. So he'll have a second to perform. The score on difficulty, well, that's the open-ended score, but each vault has a specific value. You can see it on the scoreboard there behind in the distance. 5.4 for this particular Yurchenko vault. And then the execution score is the mark given out of 10 by the judges for how well that vault is performed. And once both vaults have been performed, then the average of those two scores is taken. 14.533. That's a good start for Dominic. 9.133 on execution. So he's improved. He's done that vault then, Craig, marginally better than he managed in qualifying.
Yeah, and this is what the vault's all about, really. It's about being consistent on both vaults. No point having a brilliant big vault and then the second one sitting back down, but great start. This is a more difficult vault, so they have to do a different entry and exit from the table, but with more difficulty comes greater risk.
Here he goes then.
So we'll be doing the triple twist in Yurchenko. Wraps in, the triple twist, one pace on landing. That is a very, very good opening for Dominic Cunningham.
Well, opportune time for Christian Thomas to join us in the commentary box here. World bronze for Christian on this FPS Vavrotis in 2013. And you know Dominic very well, of course, don't you?
I do, and to be honest, it's his first World Championships. He's stepped up to the mark straight away, making a vault final. First up, which is so, so difficult as well. You kind of set the tone of the final, and he's delivered two near-perfect vaults there. Here's the Yurchenko one, wraps into the triple twist, lots of height, gets all the way around the triple twist, so no or minimal deductions on that, and then just a small step back as well.
Really interesting, the order of the competition. They announced that the gymnasts come out and don't have a warm-up. I think going up first is a real advantage in this competition. If you think you're eighth and you've no warm-up time, do you think the draw really suit Dominic?
Potentially. I think that's definitely one way that you can look at it. You know, you get up, you get it out the way. You're not sitting there watching all the other vaults coming up before you. So when you're sitting there, those nerves kind of they start to add up a little bit.
Well, 14.666 for his overall score. I think he's pretty pleased with that. Again, it's better than he managed in qualifying. So as the first gymnast out, he has now set the marker. He's put in two good, clean vaults, and you can't ask for more than that. So from Dom Cunningham, we move on to Shek Wei Hung, the 27-year-old from Hong Kong, the reigning Asian Games champion on vault. So his first vault has a difficulty value of 5.6. Christian, over to you.
Shek Wei Hung now been on the international scene for quite a few years, known as a bit of a vault specialist. There's the Dragulescu vault, so the handspring with the double front and the half turn. Quite a low landing, but execution-wise, very, very clean.
Yeah, he said he's been around for a while. 8 world championships in total, the best he's managed on the vault so far was a 6th place finish in 2014.
Well, it's not the oldest in this vault final, but you can see he really does have to power down that runway. Gymnasts have 25 metres to run. The vaulting platform or table is set at 1.35 meters. You can see the double front half turn there. As Christian pointed out, shoulders and chest down a little bit there, which the judges will pick up there. The half turn, and had to take that slight adjustment to the side. But big vault, should score relatively well.
Vault number two coming up.
You can see the mental rehearsal there. Just before his next vault, I believe it is the triple twist. And you could sort of see him imitating what position he wants to put his hands onto the vault, getting that line correct. So obviously, if the hand placement isn't correct, then that means that he's going to be outside the boundaries. So really important last minute preparation there.
Well, he scored well for vault number one. Can he get a good clean landing? His all important second vault.
Powers down the vault run. There's the triple twist. A couple of steps back on the landing. Did have lots of height and lots of rotation, which unfortunately meant a couple of steps back. But overall, not too bad. I think Dom should be safe, though, looking at the 2 volts and averaging them between them.
Just remind us exactly what the judges are looking at when they are assessing the execution and how well a vault's performed.
So they're looking at the flight onto the vault. So what are the legs doing? What are the arms doing? So if we look here onto the replay, do the legs split? There's a little split there, so the judge will take. They're looking at the height of the vault, the rotation, obviously the landings as well, and then also what it looks like in the air. So are the legs jammed together? Are the toes pointed? So there's lots and lots of areas that the judges can take deductions. And I guess it's this one in the air, though, actually very, very clean, I have to say. It's just an unfortunate landing that he's had to take those few steps back to adjust.
I'm going to say on the landing there, it looked like he came into the ground twisting slightly with his hips back. It forced him to swivel a bit backwards and take that large step. It's always a difficult vault from the Sukahara, the half on, into the triple twist. We see lots of gymnasts doing it from the Sukahara like Dominic did. But like you said, I think that should just be enough to keep Dominic in that top spot. This young man qualified down in eighth position, but he's the Asian Games champion.
Yes, 14.366. He does slot in just behind Dom Cummingham at the top of the leaderboard. To 8 gymnasts in all, though, to come. So we've got another 6, including this man you see there at the end of the runway, Nikita Nagorny. 21 years of age, part of a really up-and-coming Russian team. They took silver in the team events, and next, in particular Nagorny, bronze in the all-around.
Nikita Nagorny.
So on vault, just missed out on an Olympic medal. Came 5th in Rio, but is a former European champion on this apparatus and a first vault with a value of 5.6 to start with.
And that is, again, the Draglescu. We know he's been so consistent on this vault over these championships. He's been competing multiple days, so I'm sure the legs are feeling a tad tired by now. But again, he just powers down the vault run, propels himself into the air, and just as clean as he has been doing. Really, really difficult vault to be competing on such a regular basis.
Well, he's such a powerful all-round gymnast, but you can see the difference between the first double front half turn we've seen and that one there of Nagorny. He really does accelerate the heels from the springboard drives. We call it a double front somersault, but it's actually 2.5. He's got plenty of time to spot the floor, initiate the half turn. There you can see, look at the floor. Super vaulting, qualified in 4th on this piece of apparatus and certainly wanting to go one better.
He is challenging for a medal, isn't he? This is his 5th individual final at the Worlds. We saw him on floor final yesterday where he came 5th on the rings. Didn't have a great time in pommels, he came off. But yeah, having gone through the all-around as well, 14.8. He really willing those legs to give him all the strength and power that he can for this second vault. There's Dom leading the way so far. So another 5.6 for Nagorny.
Always a bit nerve-wracking being that first gymnast. You know you've put in 2 good vaults, but you've got to wait and sit and watch all the other gymnasts go out there. Okay, now we're ready for his second vault. Again, tacks the vault. Just short on the land. You could see as he came into the mats, he was still twisting. It was the triple twist, so an extremely difficult vault. But to me, just looked a little bit low on the height. Didn't quite get the vertical lift that I think he needed. And hence the reason that he was still twisting into the ground a little bit. But he seems to be walking away from it fine, so hopefully no damage done.
What did you make of that one, Craig?
Well, I have to agree with Christian there, actually. He didn't just have the same block as he had going forwards with a handspring, but gymnasts must do a different entry. The half on wraps in to the triple twist. His knees buckled. You can see the heavy strapping there on his ankles. And gymnasts must really finish the twist and stand up. You can see it was probably about 7/8 the way around. And so the judges will pick up on that. Good in the air, good form. And this is a big vault, the triple twist, but he just loses tension a little bit. Did very well, actually, to stop his knees touching the mat.
Yeah, the first thing to say, of course, is that if the feet aren't the first thing that touches the mat, it is a no vault. And you do see in qualifying gymnasts who land flush on their backside first if things go wrong. 14.65. Cunningham still leads the way. Well, Nagorny coming into this, challenging for a medal. So this is a first good sign for Dom Cunningham. He holds on to top spot. Looking like a cool customer, but there are some very big vaulters to come. And this man is the reigning Olympic champion. He was the top qualifier. Look at that start value. You saw there a big number six on the board, Christian.
Absolutely. So he's been a vault specialist for a number of years now. Well known for this, the Dragulescu, but in the piked position. So an extremely, extremely difficult vault. Really has to attack the runway. There's the lift, and he makes it round at the slight bend legs. If we're being super critical, I know at this sort of level it is, seems a little harsh to be that critical, but it's exactly what the judges are looking at. You can see that he had to separate the legs slightly as well just to increase the rotation.
Well, certainly it's more difficult, the pike position, but as you say there, Christian, in the second somersault, he sort of pulls his legs apart to increase the rotation a little bit, to initiate that half turn there. A little bit scrappy into the second part of the vault. However, it is a huge six difficulty, so he can afford to take the deduction and that little step to the side. At 33 years of age.
I was about to say, he's the oldest man in this competition. Perhaps not looking quite as fresh-faced as some of the other others in the lineup here today. But yeah, reigning Olympic champion, two-time world champion as well, 2014 and 2015, he held the title. Worth pointing out that the reigning world champion is in this competition as well, Kenzo Shirai of Japan. He'll be the penultimate gymnast to go. So these are really the big guns challenging. 14.933 for that first. So execution, not quite hitting the nines, but he gets that big boost by the extra difficulty on the vault.
Absolutely, and he's got a cushion on his second vault as well on the difficulty. He's doing two somersaults with the full turn, so the full in back out. Again, an extremely difficult vault. There's not too many gymnasts in the world that actually have competed or can compete this vault. So still very, very rare, even though he has been competing himself for quite a number of years now. There's the two somersaults, the full turn. And wow, absolutely incredible vault there. Easily spotted the floor, only a small step on the landing. And that's definitely going into top spot.
That is so impressive, Craig Heap, isn't it?
It certainly is. And you can see just the amount of the attack up to the springboard and the power that it generates. As you can see there, all the other gymnasts tower above him. So he's a very small gymnast, but just look at the acceleration here. Big concentration, the half on, a double back with a full turn. Yes, he takes a few adjustments on the landing, but this is such a massive vault, straight down the middle. Yeah, he had a 15.033 in qualification for that vault. And this is what stands him out. He's the only gymnast with 2 6 vaults. So it really is head and shoulders above the rest on this piece of apparatus, Christian.
Well, yeah, you can see there, he actually finished his first somersault with a full twist, and still way above the vaulting table. And when we've seen it then, he attacks the front of the vault, which then propels him up vertically. And he's finding that balance between getting the height but also getting the rotation.
And that is good enough for top spot. 14.933, the average score. And, well, tremendous vaulting. He's knocked Dom Cunningham out the way for the moment. Now, Cunningham then sitting in the silver medal position and some really big vaulters to come. But it is then the reigning Olympic champion, top of the tree, as we now have a look at Artur Davtyan. He's another one who's just about into his 30s, 30 years old, in his first vault final, despite this being his fourth world championships, but has some form on this apparatus at the European level, certainly. That's a look of concentration and focus.
Zavatun already competed in the all-round, which he did very, very well. There's the double front half turn, so the drag lesko slightly low on the landing. Could see having to take that hop forward. But overall, not too bad a vault, I have to say.
It's amazing how popular that vault's become over the years, because you haven't performed a double front before. And in, you know, as a gymnast, probably the double front is a more difficult vault to land, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, potentially, absolutely, because you have got that sort of blind landing. But it seems that the drag lesko vault is now the norm. That is the standard that is set. And, you know, contribute to why I retired when I did.
Well, you can see there, he blocks in one, two, and there's the half turn. So what we mean by is, if you do the double front, it's a blind landing. You have to kick out and land on your feet, where this vault's really popular, because as they do the second somersault, they can do a half turn, spot the floor, and hopefully execute a reasonable landing. Just lost a little bit of tension in his knees there and buckled a bit. And this is where you need the height, is really important.
Taking a well-earned breather between vaults here. 14-4-3-3 for his first. So he actually performed that vault slightly better in qualification. You come into a final always wanting to at least do as well as you've done to get there and hope to even up your game. So got a little bit of ground to make up, even on his own performance here with the second vault. But he did qualify in third spot for this final. Another 5.6.
So I believe his second vault, he does opt to twist as opposed to doing the somersaults. So a very competent vaulter being able to do vault two vaults, one twist, one somersault. And there's a triple twist. And you could see as he came out for that landing, and his shoulders were back over the back of his heels, which then meant his rotation was taking him away from the vaulting table and having to turn, take those extra steps. Very unfortunate.
Well, we've seen quite a few triple twists in this, and I think probably he watched the others that landed a little bit short, and he was probably thinking, I'm going to have to give it plenty of power. And I think he just overcooked it a little bit. And that's always the problem with this piece of apparatus. I mean, it really does power down that runway. You can see their feet together on the way on from the springboard. There's not many gymnasts that do the half on and can keep the feet together. And as you can see there, he was still twisting as he came round. There you go, wraps in. Not bad for the alignment, but hips back. And then those steps. And you can see he's very disappointed with the second vault.
Mm. You mentioned the versatility of being able to do somersault and twist. It tends to be that a vaulter is very definitely stronger at one than the other.
Absolutely. I always prefer the somersaults. It's one less thing to think about. Just get a good block and you wrap in for some sort. Dom is probably more of a twister. However, he is also very competent doing somersaults as well. Same with Kenzo. Although he can sort of twist like a topspin, he can also produce somersaults. So, it's just, I guess, working to your specialist area.
Going to that low score then, 13-4-3-3 in the 3/10 penalty for that second vault. So overall, unlikely to be challenging. And so Davtian fifth, but look at that, Dominic Cunningham with three gymnasts to go in the silver medal position. That big score set by the reigning Olympic champion, Reise Guang. Can Dom Cunningham hang on for what would be Great Britain's only second ever vault medal, behind the one that Christian Thomas, a man sitting next to me, won in 2013. For now though, Cal Souza of Brazil going through his mental preparations. So also a man in his first world vault final, 5.6 vaults for Christian Thomas to describe.
So here he goes into the triple twist, a very easy round actually. I think over the past, I remember competing with the 2.5 twists, especially for Rio Olympics, but he's obviously upgraded into the triple twist now. So it's something he's been working quite hard on in the training gym, but looked a relatively easy vault, I have to say.
Well, he's certainly got plenty of power in those shoulders. There you go, a little bit of a leg split on the way on, but it does travel through the air really well. Wraps into that triple twist. I think he just about stays inside the lines. There you go, a little leg split. Easy to one side. Whoa. But yeah, really good vault. This is the best of his two vaults from qualification, even though both on 5.6. Plenty of time in the air and just that big pace on the landing.
So 14.633 for that first vault. Can he build on that now with the second? He'll have to be given the go by the judges. So it's another 5.6 for Souza.
Always slightly difficult to try and compose yourself once you've received a good score from the first vault. Sometimes you get slightly excited, slightly ahead of yourself sometimes, so you kind of just have to bring yourself in a little bit more, compose yourself. Good speed there in the runway. There's the Dragulescu, but you could see didn't quite get the lift off the top of the vault. He looked like he got a block, but I don't know whether maybe his arms bent slightly too much as it the somersault seemed to drop down to earth pretty fast.
And hands down on the mat.
Absolutely, the hands down, that's of the obvious deduction with the half turn. It just didn't quite have the same lift as some of the other Dragulescus that we've seen so far.
A very powerful vault of their blocks. You can see he didn't really have the height of the Dragulescus that we've seen so far. I don't know whether he didn't just get his hands in quick enough to the vault, but maybe went into that tuck position, very cowboyed as well. So that'll be a big penalty.
Well, Dom Cunningham will be watching these vaults, knowing that he was first, and everyone else will be looking to try and knock him down the order. And you see gymnasts make mistakes. I think, well, it's going to help Dom's cause.
Certainly is. With two to go, we just need maybe one of those remaining gymnasts to make a bit of a mistake, and could be good news for Dom.
So Souza is down in sixth place with two more gymnasts to come, 13.883 overall. And Cunningham then still in the silver medal position. But Kenzo Shirai, who's next to go, is the reigning world champion, Olympic bronze medalist at Rio as well. And he is he's a real twister, isn't he? We've seen him on the floor with his quadruple twist. But here he has already seen one world title be taken away from him in these championships, because he was the three-time defending floor champion. And he lost that gold medal to, in fact, the man who's last to go on vault, Arta Dalaloyan. So Shirai will be absolutely eager to try and hang on to this particular world title, Christian.
Absolutely, and he's going to start with the triple twist. There's the block. Slight step on landing, almost sticks it. His shoulders were slightly low, hence the step forward, but a great opening vault for Kenzo.
Well, a bit of a fighting landing, Craig, but he held it.
Well, certainly, and I think one of the problems is if you're going to win, we've seen this before, look, he blocks, wraps in, triple twist, he went to nail that, and because his chest was down a little bit, it won't be too costly. There we can see, triple twist in the middle. Actually, that is quite deep a landing in the chest, so the judges will pick up heavily on that. And actually, if you compare it to Dominic's, maybe Dominic's was the better of the two. And maybe the pressure's on. He still has to perform a second vault. And I know in qualification he did an easy second vault to get in, so he'll be raising the difficulty.
Yeah, of course, we should point out that if scores are tied at all, then it is the E value that judges will look at. So you don't always have to do the most difficult routine, in this case most difficult vaults, but for that one, 14.75, that's a very good score for that first vault at 5.6 difficulty. So interesting to see now whether he does up that difficulty, but also whether he'll go for a really high execution score. Staring down that vault runway, what is going through his mind? It's another 5.2, so it is what he did in qualifying. He'll be looking to do this one extremely cleanly, Christian.
Yes, I think to make sure he stays amongst the men, he's got to pretty much nail it. And he does exactly just that. I mean, to be honest, I don't even know how he nailed that, because it didn't really look like it got the lift off the vault. But the way that he can spin and stick those vaults is absolutely incredible.
Well, that big smile suggests that he feels he's done enough, perhaps, to get on that podium. So we'll find out very shortly. Congratulations all around from everybody down there on the floor. There's always such great camaraderie between gymnasts, no matter what the country. But just to remind you, Dom Cunningham sitting in the silver medal position at the moment. We await the score of Kenzo Shirai and then one more gymnast to come.
Well, you can see on the replay there, opted for the 2.5 twist. It did look like he was a little bit early turning on the top, which makes them go to one side of the mat. There you can see he wraps in, no problem in the air, so especially aware. But just look, he travels to the line there. So whether that's a point one, to decide he went over, but it was very clean. He stuck the landing. I think he might just be good enough to go into second place.
And he does. 14.675 overall. So Dom Cunningham is knocked down into the bronze medal position with just one more gymnast to go. So whether Cunningham is able to bag a world medal here will depend on how Artur Dalaloyan does for Russia, who you have to say, Craig, is having the, well, it's the world championships of his life at the moment, isn't it? He's just excelled for his team for Russia, all around gold, floor gold. He's already a double world champion. And what's he got in the vault locker to challenge for a medal now?
Well, he has got two really big vaults, 5-6 on difficulty. I don't think he's going to be good enough to challenge for first unless he absolutely sticks them, but these are two really big vaults. So, yes, I think we're all sitting on the edge of our seats for Dominic Cunningham. Can he hang on to that bronze medal?
Dalaloyan is the reigning two-time European vault champion. He's the last man to go here. He's got two vaults to try and get on the podium.
Well, most powerful approach that we've seen, but no problem there. Ops first of all for the Yurchenko. That's the round off onto the springboard, backflip onto the vaulting platform, and three twists. I think much of a muchness what we've seen from triple twists. He was obviously going to stick it and obviously shoulders down a little bit, but technically very good. It'd be difficult for the judges to take deductions from that.
Well, we saw him at the Worlds in 2017. He finished last in the vault final there. Wrapping himself in, just that one small hop on landing.
Yeah, and the judges are looking from block from the top. He had good flight, a little bit, you could say probably 7/8 round, a little bit of a little twist as he stands up, but this is good. I mean, we've seen a real shift in the Russian team over the past 18 months, 2 years, from where they've come from really behind to really excel at these championships, and certainly, you know, staking a fork in the ground really for 2020.
14.866. That is a big score for first vault. 9.266 on execution. This is the man at the top of the leaderboard there. Kenzo Shirai in the silver medal position at the moment. Cunningham occupying bronze. We're going to see a lot of Dalaloyan this afternoon because he's also got parallel bars and high bar final to come as well. An outstanding gymnast after some rocky episodes in his career. He was kicked off the Russian team when he was younger for lack of discipline. He was left out of Rio, which has really given him the impetus to come back to these worlds as he has, perform quite brilliantly. Final vault of this competition.
Well, it's a big vault. Hold your breath. Wraps in, handspring, double flat, pike front, somersault. Just that step on landing. Well, unfortunately, I think that will be good enough to beat Dominic Cunningham. It will get a medal, but what colour? That was a cracking vault. Might just push for silver.
Brilliant vaulting. I saw the reaction of Nikita Nagorny, his Russian teammate. Delight on his face, power down that runway.
He has plenty of time there. We obviously, gymnasts do this in the tuck position. I was talking earlier to Kristen about this is a blind landing, because what we mean is you've got to open out going forward at the right time. And Christian won his medal, he did this in the tuck position. So you really need to generate a lot of heel drive from the springboard to get into that pike position, open out in plenty of time. Two super vaults. I think he's really riding the wave of this competition and championships.
McCorney's reaction, watching from the sidelines. Qualified in second place. Imagine it's going to be a medal. Just what colour? Dom Cunningham, just to put his achievement in context even, because say the only medal that Great Britain have had on vault was Christian's bronze. And Dalaloyan takes the silver with 14.883 overall. It means that that man there is the world champion, the new world champion. And Dominic Cunningham just squeezed out of the medals, but he finishes fourth in the vault final in his very first world championships, which, Craig, you have to say, is just another huge result for Great Britain.
It certainly is, and a huge boost for Dominic Cunningham as well. European floor champion, Commonwealth bronze champion, fourth. He had some of the lower start values in this, so he's got the execution. If he could just get his start values up, and that will probably take a couple of years, he will be a real contender. So well done, Dominic Cunningham.
Kenzo Shirai has lost his world title. It's gone to the Olympic champion, who's now also the world champion, Rise Guang. And Arthur Dalaloyan, another medal to add to his fantastic worlds with the silver. Dominic Cunningham, though, fourth place for him, just missing out on the medal. But Britain's second best result in a world vault final for Dom Cunningham.
Oh, congratulations to Dom Cunningham, but so agonising for him because he's 0.09 off a mark, off the medals. And it was Shirai who just pipped him there. But let's have a quick look back from Dom's perspective. Christian, you remain the only British gymnast to ever claim a vault medal. That was 5 years ago, and he was so close here to joining you.
He was. And to be honest, I think we have to remember it's still only his first World Championships, which... that is a big step, just to even make the vault final. You know, you looked at those vaults, those all so clean. And Dom can be really proud of himself here. It's a platform for him to work off. This first vault, I think he's kind of got down to a T now. He seems to be able to just nail that vault 9 times out of 10. And potentially, there's also scope for an extra half turn, creating more difficulty. So there's his half on, good block, legs together, spots the landing. And hopefully, over the coming sort of months, we can... what sort of work in the gym on that and doing the extra half turn.
I think what was really impressive, both vaults, the execution score were both over 9. Yep. And obviously the adrenaline was flowing, he's first out there, but he seemed to make that work for him, Beth.
He did, and obviously we've spoken so much about the execution here. I mean, his legs are locked together throughout. And obviously that is his second vault, so you don't necessarily compete it as many times. If you're just doing an all-around competition, he'll use that first vault. So over time, he'll increase his consistency on that one. And we've seen him so many times in training nail both of those landings. So he's definitely got huge potential on this piece in the future.
Well, congratulations to Dom. Next time, perhaps.
Yeah.
But this is the third time for Rise Guang of North Korea. Now, he's an oldie but a goodie at 33 years of age. And when we were talking about this, you were saying these vaults he's attempting are positively scary.
They are, and it can pay off or it can't. We've seen him in other championships where he's landed really short, hurt his ankles. But, I mean, that first vault, he's pretty much the only person in the world that's competing this. He uses the handspring entry, huge block, the double pike. But because he has got that increased difficulty, he can get away with the steps on the landing. And he had 0.4 up on anyone else on difficulty.
And the second vault in particular, Christian, when you look at this, I mean, you did indeed pull off one of the scariest and most difficult vaults of them all in your time. But as someone who can achieve this sort of level, how do you rate this performance?
Well, I think it's just the fact that he seems to be doing it now on a very, very consistent basis. These are extremely difficult vaults. And probably previously, maybe even going back 5 years, you could see he was sometimes struggling with the consistency of doing it at every single major championships. But World Championships last year, Rio Olympics, this year's World Championships. He just seems to keep knocking those vaults now out of the ballpark and just doing a fantastic job with them. So it's really very, very impressive.
Yes, indeed. He's the Rio Olympic champion. And, of course, he'll be looking at 35 years young to be going to Tokyo as well. It's remarkable, isn't it? But so too is Arthur Dalalayan of Russia, because we talked in the early part of this week about the possibility of Simone Biles achieving 6 medals in 6 pieces. This guy could do exactly the same because he's still got 2 more pieces to come. This is his 2nd silver to go with his 2 golds so far. And this gymnast has really come of age at these championships.
He has. He obviously had that real big disappointment at the beginning of the week where he had the fall and the team went into 2nd place. But going into the all-around, going into the apparatus finals, I mean, this vault is incredible. You've got a blind landing, the block that he gets, his legs are tight throughout, and he just has that one step. But he's really improving in confidence, and like you say, he's still got 2 more pieces of apparatus and has already got 2 golds and 2 silver.
And he seems to create time in the air. I mean, he has so much time to open out from that pike and stand beautifully on his feet.
Yeah, absolutely. I think his technique, he's got down to a T. His heel drive, you can see where he lifts the heels into the vault. That gets him the rotation, the block off the vaulting table. That gets him the height. So combining those two together, that's the vault that he comes away with.
Absolutely. OK, so we've got a North Korean winner, and that's the 15th different nation to claim a medal at these World Championships this week. And we've got Arthur Dalalayan with a 4th medal here and counting, because he's still got 2 more pieces to come this afternoon. But we're counting the medals from Simone Biles' perspective as well. Super Simone, what a week this young lady has had.
Absolutely phenomenal.
Simone Biles, yet another world gold medal. Her 12th world championship gold. She just looks like it was a walk in the park. As Simone Biles, for the first time, is world vault champion. Simone Biles with the silver, her first major medal on this apparatus.
Yeah, 3 out of 4 golds ain't bad, and she's got that bronze and the uneven bars as well, so it's all going to plan as far as she's concerned. But Beth, it's the dreaded beam next. Now, normally we'd be super confident about Simone's aptitude on this. After all, she's a 2-time world champion, she's the reigning Olympic champion. But there's maybe just a little bit of shakiness in the mind here, because rather uncharacteristic errors from her on this little 10-centimetre wide piece of apparatus this week.
Yeah, we have seen a couple of errors. So obviously this was the one from the team final where she put her hand down, and she was so frustrated and disappointed with herself. We could see when she did the interview after the competition, she doesn't like making mistakes. Obviously no gymnast does, and then again in the all-around, and this is a skill I've never seen her fall off in. So uncharacteristic falls from her, but obviously she's had a long week of competition. But I think the fact that she's had 2 bad beam routines, hopefully we're going there 3rd time lucky and she'll go for the gold. But I mean, the difficulty that she's got still allows her to pick up medals.
How much is that going to play with her head though? I mean, you know what it's like to fall off, get back up again, but does it make you think before you go back on for your next routine? Will it make her think?
I don't think she can allow it to play with her head, because obviously she's going into another world final. She's so experienced, she's been into numerous finals, she's been medalist on this piece before, so I think she'll just forget about it. There's nothing you can do about that performance, and she'll be going into today's with a clear mind.
But she's 21, 15-year-old Kara Eaker, her teammate from America. She's been brought here simply for this piece of apparatus. What makes her stand out?
She's got a real class of elegance about her. I mean, it's so difficult at 15 years old to just come out in the team final and perform on this piece of apparatus and not even show a slight bit of nerves. So it'll be interesting to see, obviously, how she copes with the pressure in her first world final, obviously only being 15 and not getting that warm-up on the apparatus.
You know, Christian, we've been talking about Simone Biles all week here, and as you join us today, you've been retired, what, about a year now, something like that? Can you imagine stopping for a year, as she did, and coming back even better than you were before, just a few months later?
Absolutely not. I mean, I watched those videos and my shoulders just hurt watching them, let alone actually getting back up there and doing it again. So, absolute just credit to her.
What do you make of her as a gymnast and what she's actually doing in terms of pushing this sport now?
Well, I think she's just incredible. There's nothing short of incredible of what she's and where she's going and how she's helped raise the platform and the profile of the sport. I think she is really once in a generation gymnast.
She sure is. OK, Biles is up first in the beam final, so we'll hand back to Craig Heath and Alison Mitchell.
Thank you. We're in for a scintillating beam final here. Simone Biles going for what would be, if she can get it, a 14th career gold. When she won the vault gold, that took her to 13 world titles, more golds than any other gymnast in history in world championships, male or female. So first up here, two-time a world champion on this piece of apparatus, but bronze in 2016. After an error, and it has been the piece where she's faltered at times, Craig Heap. Let's see how she goes here.
Relatively quiet mount, jumping to the beam. There's nothing quiet about this routine. One, two, three, triple spin with no hesitation. Straight into a leap combination, so straight away she gets through two of the requirements. This is a difficult front somersault half turn. That's where she put her hand down the other day, so she did a little bit better there. This is where she stands out, almost tumbling on this piece of apparatus. The flick into the layout. Another one of the requirements, acrobatic series. And characteristic there with that step, and another little wobble into a standing back, pipe back. Very difficult pike front somersault. So the gymnasts have to keep the routine moving. Let's have a little bit of pace about it, which this certainly does. Free walk over into a split leap. Does look a bit hesitant, but this is the big dismount. Only one in the world. Flick, full twisting double back. Well, no falls today. Maybe smiles from Biles on the beam.
Well, she's always one to finish strongly on that piece of apparatus, isn't she? But I just wonder, Beth Tweddle, how confident, how smooth was that routine? It's incredibly acrobatic, isn't it?
It is. You can see that she starts off very well here with the triple squat spin. And watching that routine, obviously, we've seen her have mistakes this week, but she was very edgy throughout the whole routine, which we're not used to seeing. If she does have the falls, that's usually all that happens. Everything else is solid. But throughout that routine, there was lots of little hesitant wobbles here and there. So she will be deducted for all of those mistakes throughout.
And going
but
back
obviously,
to what
I think she'll be pleased that she's stayed on.
I was going to say, just going back to what Hazel was saying in the studio, to have a year out, you can't practice the number of competitions, experience, and obviously this piece of apparatus, it is such a difficult piece, and this is one what you really need to practice.
Yeah, and I think this is one that you do need competition experience. You can have a year out, you can get the skills back, but replicating that nervous feeling, that feeling of being out there and performing in front of the judges is quite difficult to do back in your own training environment. So here you can see a great somersault connection, the flick into the layout. Gymnasts will pick up a series bonus for having three elements connected together there. She's nervously waiting for her score to come through.
Well, she has a difficult routine, but 6.2, only 7.4 for execution, so 13.6, that is some way down from what she managed in qualifying.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, like we were saying, those little wobbles, they're 0.1s, they're 0.3s, and they soon add up, and that's what allowed this 7.2 execution score. Opens the door for other gymnasts.
Well, it really does, simply in terms of getting on the podium even for Simone Biles. Ellie Black, then, of Canada. Been in a number of world beam finals, never managed to get on the podium, though.
So a very powerful gymnast, a great opening connection. Not too sure whether they'll give that last little connection. There's the double spin. Gymnasts have to show a full spin on the beam. And here builds up for a big somersault connection. There's the flip into the straight back. No problems there. A very powerful gymnast. There's the side somersault. Controls that very well. Builds up to the dismount. There's the round off into the double pike. Only the small step forward. A great routine, and will be interesting to see, actually, because she scored a 13.733 in qualification, so that routine didn't have any major mistakes.
It didn't, and it's just going to prove that maybe Biles is not going to have it all her own way on this piece of apparatus. I mean, it's a real feel there. There's an Olympic champion, current European champion to go, but yeah. She's really come on over the past few years as Ellie Black, not just on this piece of apparatus, but as an all-rounder. Canadian team have moved up the ranks. That's a very difficult spin to control. Double spin. And with the acrobatic series there, you can see the flick into the straight back somersault. No problem at all. And a big dismount, round off into the double pike back. See, looking for the legs, straight. Plenty of time to spot the landing. I think she'll be pleased with that, Beth.
I think she will be, and like we were saying, she's been in numerous world finals, but never managed to make it onto that podium.
Well, Simone Biles was first up. It's only a 13.6 for Ellie Black to beat. Sometimes it's not all about packing in the most difficulty, but you can bolster your score by performing what you can do exceedingly well. It's the execution score, the mark out of 10 for how well the gymnasts perform their routine.
Judges are deliberating over this score, whether they'll be discussing that first connection where she did the change leg onto the beam, into the change leg, into the change leg half. I'm not sure whether they'll give that final change leg half connection, and that'll alter her difficulty score.
Well, interesting, Biles' start value was down 0.2, so she didn't get connection on one of the link series. I think there was a slight hesitation. But you see, the judges, they spend hours and hours practicing their judging techniques, so they make sure that everything is connected, or they don't make the correct positions, that's deducted.
So score is on its way in. 13.6 laid down by Biles, 13.033. So you can see there the difference in the difficulty values between the two. Only a 4.8 from Ellie Black. That's where the big difference is. And Simone Biles has so much difficulty on many other gymnasts, but that's some way down on her difficulty for the start value of her routine in qualifying. It's a little strange one. From China, though, and Zhang Jin at 17 years of age is not the youngest in this competition by any means, but bronze on the beam at the Asian Games, Beth.
It is in her first World Championship final. So let's see. Chinese are renowned for this piece of apparatus, have absolutely beautiful leaps like we've just seen there with the change leg ring straight into the Corbett flick. Builds up for her first big somersault connection. There's the flick to one, flick to two, into the straight back. Unfortunately, just offline, has to try and fight it, but can't. Gymnasts have a set amount of time to get back up and compose themselves. She's straight back up. There's the free walkover into the split jump and to the next jump. They have to show two jumps linked together. There's more leaps and jumps. Unfortunately, just misplaces her feet on the landing. And this is a test of character now, having to pick herself back up to finish this routine off. Still got a couple of elements to do. It's very different competing in a world final. All eyes are on you. There's the big dismount into the triple twist. Didn't quite get the height and buckled with those knees on landing.
Well, you think fair play for how quickly she got back up the beam every time, though. You get the sympathetic applause from the crowd, but she was having none of it. Straight back up there. Got to hand it to her for that.
Well, another piece of apparatus, you have 30 seconds, but the beam, I think, Beth, you have about 10 seconds, so you can't hang around. And probably showing a little bit of, you know, nerves, lack of experience, first World Championships, even though she has done the Asian Games. They are so beautiful to watch, and they have their own elegance, the Chinese gymnasts, but often renowned for that lack of consistency. That was a very big acrobatic series, the flick to one leg, flick to two, into the straight back somersault. So graceful to watch, and you can definitely see the difference in gymnastics between, let's say, the routine construction of the Chinese and the Americans, wouldn't you say, Beth?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the Chinese, we saw a lot of leaps and jumps throughout that routine, and then you've got maybe more the more powerful that we've seen from Ellie Black and Simone Biles, but every gymnast will have their strengths, and obviously the coach will have worked with them for a number of years to be able to work out which route to go down.
Well, in qualifying, she had one of the most difficult routines. She was right up there with the leading pack and qualified in third place. So huge disappointment for her to have come off twice during that routine. But if you haven't seen the beam before, 5 meters long, only 10 centimeters wide. So no wider than average smartphone or a house brick, perhaps. It's a fiendishly difficult piece of apparatus, a real feat of precision. And it claims its fair number of victims, particularly in big finals like this one. You have to feel for her, don't you, watching her there?
You do, and you usually find with the beam final, it is a case of who can hold the nerve and who can stay on. It usually ends up on the medal podium.
And you're right about all eyes being on you. I mean, usually in an all-around competition, in a team final competition, there's gymnasts on every other piece going around the hall, and there's all sorts going on. But 11.5 then, so just the 6.2 for execution brings Xinjiang's score right down.
Judges are being really harsh on the combinations. Another one down 7/10 on the difficulty.
Well, this is a terrific gymnast. Nina Dowal, we saw her become Belgium's first ever world champion with bars gold yesterday. And she's a European silver medalist on beam. So let's see what she can do.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. Obviously, having all that emotion and adrenaline from last night's final and then having to pick yourself back up and get onto a piece where you've got to have really steady nerves, but a great opening mount with the layout and then straight into her first connection. There, just a little wobble on the free walkover. Nice side somersault, has to fight to stay on. Very elegant gymnast. There's the leap connection. Shows 180 degree in the splits. And the popular squat spin. There's the triple. Very well executed. Has a bit of originality in there with the dance. Going straight back into the double squat spin. So picks up high level of difficulty for those two spin elements. And we'll use a different dismount to what we've seen other gymnasts using. Here's the gainer with the full turn. A great routine. Obviously scored a 13.766 in qualification, but only had a 5.2 difficulty. So it will be interesting to see where that difficulty is today.
And just a couple of wobbles overall. She looks to have so much poise and grace on the beam.
Yes, she has, and for a tall gymnast, when she can show the flexibility and the separation there, it does look extremely good. There you can see, look, flick into the layout somersault. A little bit of an arm flicker there, but did well. Got to keep your hips square with the beam. Remember, it's only 10 centimetres wide. And she did well there, certainly in the arms, in the side somersault, not to come off.
So we saw in the qualification, she had a 5.2 difficulty, and Simone posted a 6.2 difficulty today. So it'll be interesting to see. That could make the difference.
Well, an unusual dismount, as you said, Beth, there. The gainer, back somersault gainer, means you need to travel away from the apparatus. That's a skill in itself, with a full twist.
Oh, she must have been on an absolute high overnight after winning that world gold yesterday on bars. 13.466. She's up there amongst the medals, but not quite enough yet to topple Simone Biles off top spot. Oh, she continues to impress, though, Nina Doal, throughout these World Championships. 5.4 difficulty, and that's the real difference between her and Biles, isn't it?
It is indeed, yeah.
Right, from Canada then, we've seen Ellie Black perform, now her teammate Anne-Marie Padaroru, just 16 years of age, been her first year as a senior here at these World Championships.
Yep, and we've seen her in a beam final at the Pan American Games, so we know that she's been in finals before. There, the triple squat spin, a great way to start the routine. Judges are looking for their top eight elements, and one of those has to be the dismount. So it builds up the difficulty as she's working through this routine. Here's the free cartwheel into the layout. A very difficult combination. Picks up the series bonus for having the three elements together. There's the change leg half. Has a very fast pace on this routine, keeping the rhythm. There's the two jumps that they have to show. And you can hear her teammates in the background cheering her on. Just got the dismount, built up for the double pike. And a small step back. You can see the delight on her face with that.
Wow, that is one happy gymnast.
That was a fantastic routine. And I think that, if the difficulty is given, can challenge for that top spot.
Yeah, she had 6.1 difficulty in qualifying. And that was so well executed on top of that beam.
And for me, one of the few B-room teams that we've seen so far in this final, where she got on the beam and she looked in control from start to finish. And as Beth picked up, it had a real pace about it, that routine. And that comes with confidence. We've seen a lot of stop-start. And for somebody so young, at 16 years of age, a real accomplished routine. I mean, this is such a difficult acrobatic series. The free cartwheel into the layout, into a layout somersault. And there, just a slight arm flicker. But for me, that is the best beam routine we've seen so far. Split jump, showing great flexibility. Good choreography. And then a big dismount as well. High, lifts up, double pipe back somersault. And just that little pace, step back on the landing. Smiles all around. Brilliant routine. Well,
she looks
done.
Like she has a natural feel for this piece of apparatus. Some gymnasts just find beam a lot easier than others.
Oh, I think we could see some delight amongst the Canadian contingent here. Oh, she's toppled Simone Biles. 14.1. She's in the gold medal position at 16 years of age. Her first World Championships. Just look at what that means. Well, Biles can only watch on. It won't be a gold for her, but it could yet be a gold for Anne-Marie Paderari, with three gymnasts still to come, though. Got Biles in the silver medal position, Nina Dowell occupying bronze. I rather fancy perhaps the next gymnast we see, though, could well challenge for that top spot as well, because it's Simone Biles' teammate, Kara Eka, who has also been routine packed full of difficulty.
And such a young age, and the team have brought her out here just to do beam. We saw her appear in the team final after two pieces of apparatus. So we know she can hold a nerve. Let's see whether she can do it.
Oh, I think that answered your question.
That did.
She's only 15.
So she'll recompose herself and can continue with the routine. There's the nice jumps. Always very difficult when you make that mistake so early on in the routine. Here's the free walkover into the jump. Just a small little wobble. Big somersault connection coming up. The free cartwheel into the layout. Just has to readjust at the end. There's the leap into the side somersault. No problems with that element. She's doing well to complete that routine. I love that flick into the one foot hold. A great series of elements linked all together there. Here's the change leg into the change leg side, showing great splits throughout those leaps and jumps. And just has the dismount to complete this routine. A big dismount that it is. Round off flick into the 2.5. Such a shame to have that fall so early on, because the rest of the routine was very good.
Well, it's always difficult when you start the routine and you're quickly off. And maybe she was just a little bit out of time as well then. And it's always difficult when you come, you know, this is your specialist piece. It's extra pressure knowing that that's what you're there for. And competition is so tight to get into the American team that you really need to come and deliver. But there you can see, opts for that unusual sort, really double split leap, leg split, lost the balance, shoulders to one side, and then it's really hard to compose yourself throughout that. This was good. Free walkover. Maybe a little hesitation into that leap there, so she would go to connect that. And if the judges think there's too much of a pause, then they don't get combination. But that's the big acrobatic series. And did so well there. You can see her feet gripping the beam. The determination. A little bit too much too late, unfortunately.
Definitely a one for the future, though. She's got a great routine.
Well, we saw in the team final she only did beam in that competition, didn't she? So she was brought here specifically to do that in the team competition and to perform here in the individual final after qualifying for it. Yeah, I think she's fighting back a little bit of emotion and disappointment with that when all goes wrong at the start. Oh, but look at the difference in emotion, because Anne-Marie Paderari is going to hang on to the top spot with only two gymnasts left to come. Canada have only ever had one medal on beam in the history of world gymnastics.
And they've just added to it.
Yep,
but the next competitor is definitely one that's going to want to upset her party.
Yeah, Sunny Weavers is still to come. She's the reigning Olympic and European champion.
But has never won the world title, so we'll be wanting to pick that one up.
Well, certainly within her grasp, looking at these scores, I think she was thinking Bowser might be the main competition. So, you know, if you're out there competing and the favourite falls, it almost gives you a bit of confidence. And we have seen a few cracks in the American team in this championships. Certainly gives the rest of the world that little bit of hope, and with 2 years to go, that you can catch them.
And Kara Eker will be just 17 by the time the Tokyo Olympics come around, but she'll have another whole couple of years of experience behind her before she gets that far. Simone Biles is sitting in the silver medal position with Nina Dalwal bronze, and Marie Padarara of Canada sitting up top. So the 10th penalty in 12.833. Not a good day at the office for Kara Eker in these games. Now, can the reigning Olympic champion get up amongst the medals? Sanne Weavers of the Netherlands. She's got quite an interesting, rather unique beam routine here, Beth.
Yeah, we're going to see a very different style routine now. Focuses a lot on the leaps and jumps and the spins. So if you've not seen this gymnast before, you're going to be in for a treat. So big start, the round off into the flick. Starts to build a difficulty as soon as she gets on the beam. There's the double leg spin. Manages to hold it. Big connection. Free cartwheel into the flick. Unfortunately, just offline. We spoke about earlier with Beam, with it being the person that usually can stay on will be on the podium. There's the free walkover into the jump. The nice twisting flick. Gymnasts have to show a low element on the beam. Here's the big spin series that we're used to seeing her perform. There's the third one, straight into the fourth element. Very well performed. And here's the big dismount, the full twist. A great landing. What a shame about that free cartwheel flip.
Well, third gymnast that we've seen fall in this beam final. Pressure gets to everyone. Doesn't matter how experienced you are, how many titles are behind you every final. You're almost, well, you are starting again from scratch, aren't you? So Sanne Weavers, not to be her day.
No, certainly it's a tough piece of apparatus, and the pressure would have been on, actually, generally from herself. She's seen that the main rival had fallen. One of the other gymnasts, sorry, in Biles, with that wobble. And you can see that she did so well early on to stay on the beam. And a different style of routine, as Beth said there. It's all about artistry. And in terms of acrobatic series, Beth, that's one of the simplest acrobatic series that we've seen.
Yeah, she's changed her acrobatic series. She used to do a free cartwheel straight into a free cartwheel, but sometimes there was a debate about whether it was connected. So they've re-altered it and added that in, and unfortunately it's not paid off today. But a great dismount to finish that routine off.
I'm going to say the second gainer dismount we've seen, but looks like we're going to have a real surprise on another piece of apparatus with the young Anne-Marie Padarara.
Well, I tell you, it's been a real world championships for seeing new names on the podium and even on top of the podium. Oh, plenty of smiles. there amongst the two teammates. Ellie Black there on the right, but yeah, we could be looking there at a new world champion.
Just one more competitor from China, so obviously renowned for beam, but we've seen her teammate have a couple of falls.
Well, certainly the battle for gold is going to go down to the final gymnast. She has it in her. Does Lu Tingting to challenge, certainly. But Sanae Weavers has gone the same way as Kara Ika of the USA, and Zhang Jin of China came off twice in her routine.
Well, you can see the look of disappointment in several of the gymnast faces. It is such a difficult piece of apparatus. These gymnasts spend hours and hours, but it's so difficult to recreate the pressure of a final.
And she's down in sixth place with that, 12.666. Well, there on your left, she knows she's got either a gold or a silver. Anne-Marie Paderewski, Canada's best ever result in a world beam final. This is how things stand then. The young Canadian at 16 years of age, leading from Simone Biles. No third world beam title for her today. And this now the final gymnast, Lu Tingting of China. Another teenager, 18 years of age.
As Beth said, very beautiful and graceful on this piece of apparatus. If sometimes a little inconsistent. And that is a very big skill, the handspring front somersault. Lee, and again. That was nice, split Lee into the immediate flick. He walk over and again, leap, Corbett flick. Going well so far. Confident on the turns. And the free cartwheel and again. Lee Tingting, going well so far. Needs a good dismount for a medal. Come on, stand it up. Round off, wraps into the triple twist. Well, up last, one of the best beam performances we've seen in this final. It certainly put pressure on the young Canadian.
Well, again, you couldn't ask for a better climax, could you? Top class performance from the final gymnast. Last to go on the apparatus, she had a difficulty value of 6 in qualifying, so she knew coming into it that she could challenge, particularly having seen some of the other gymnasts fall and mistakes made by Simone Biles as well. So where could this put her up amongst the medals?
Well, I think it's definitely good enough to get into the medals. Gold or silver is where my bet will be. If she matches Padaruru of Canada with a 6, she had a 6 start value in qualification. I think for me, she really did execute the routine well. Looking at good execution, straight legs, pointed toes. Wasn't too stop-start the routine. It has to keep flowing. And a big dismount to finish.
Well, it's all down to the judges now. How well do they judge that she performed that routine? Nina Darwell on the right was sitting in bronze, but Anne-Marie Paderewski on the left. Has she clung on?
Well, Canada have already picked up one silver medal on the vault yesterday with Shallon Olsen. So will it be silver or gold today?
They really are one of the up-and-coming countries in the women's side of gymnastics. As a team, even seen them climb up the rankings and start to push for podium places amongst the team competitions.
Well, they've a real breadth in the team. You've got Ellie Black, the elder, leading the team at 23. And then, you know, you have this young 16-year-old pulling them through and giving them that experience. Yeah, things do look good.
Here's the moment of truth. She's done enough for the gold. Tremendous for Lu Tingting. At 18 years of age, she is the new world champion. Tears in the arena for the young Chinese gymnast. She takes the gold for Anne-Marie Padararu of Canada. She's still delighted. That's Canada's best ever result in a world beam final. And for Simone Biles, well, she picks up her 19th world medal to go with the bronze that she won in 2013 on this piece of apparatus. But that is just so wonderful to see, tears of joy as opposed to tears of disappointment, which we've also seen in this beam final today. Full of drama, Craig, with the falls, but wonderful to see the joy on the faces of both gymnasts from Canada and also China.
Absolutely brilliant. And we've talked for years about how beautiful and graceful the Chinese gymnasts are and seem to always fail at the final furlong in the apparatus finals. It's almost like they run out of hidden momentum, so that will be great for them. Their first individual apparatus medal of these championships, and it's a gold on the beam for China.
Nina Dewaal just missed out on the medal, having become Belgium's first ever world champion yesterday with gold on the bars. She was squeezed out by a fabulous final performance from Lu Tingting. And the crowd have enjoyed the first two individual finals here. We've seen men's vault and we've now seen the beam. We've still got a number of finals to come. Parallel bars, women's floor, and then the horizontal bar to come as well. So full of drama in the beam final, but gold goes to Lu Tingting of China, Anne-Marie Padararu, Canada's best ever result with a silver in the final, and Simone Biles comes away with the bronze.
Well, 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 that wasn't in the script, was it? 18-year-old and a 16-year-old beating Simone Biles to the punch today, and we talked about this and how it might indeed just get into her head a little bit, these previous mistakes. How did you rate her performance today, Beth? Because there's a few wobbles in there.
It was, and it was normally when she does have errors, the rest of the routine is solid and she just has that one mistake, whereas today the whole thing just looked a little bit edgy, a little bit shaky, which we're just not used to seeing. So here you see the stop between the connections and yet another little wobble. So all of these wobbles are picking up point ones, point threes, and that's why, even though she had the big difficulty, her execution score was down.
Actually, Christian and I were talking when we were watching this about the fact that she has been out for such a long time in competition. Physically, she doesn't look much different in terms of her level, but in terms of handling the pressure and being in that scrutiny and feeling that pressure, that takes a wee bit of getting used to, surely, coming back.
Absolutely, and I think it's that sort of situation, that sort of pressurised environment, you can't really replicate in a training gym. You can do controlled competitions, you can sort of put your hand up to your coach, to whoever might be in the gym, but that actual live competition situation is really just once-a-lifetime experience, and that is actually just physically going out there, competing. And it, potentially, she might be just be lacking that a little bit. I don't think it's something of a massive concern. I think it's something just the longer she gets back into the sport, then it's naturally just going to come back to her and she'll start to get a feel, a flow for exactly how she was probably prior to Rio Olympics.
In other words, everybody else, make the most of this because she's going to get better. And she's got three gold, one silver and one bronze. But Padararu of Canada, this young lady who's actually trained by Elena Davidova, the 1980 Moscow all-around champion. So fantastic help in her corner here. But beautiful routine.
It was. And to be honest, it was one of the most sort of confident and fast-paced routine. Had a great start with this triple squat spin that seems to be becoming more and more popular with the gymnasts, but has really high difficulty linked to it. But the whole routine, there was never that moment of, is she, isn't she? Here's the going into a new connection. There's the free cartwheel into the layout. I mean, that is such a difficult combination to do, especially under that pressurised situation when all eyes are on you.
Well, she carried it off beautifully, and this is her first year as a senior. She only really appeared at the Canadian Nationals, and here she is in her first World Championships, going home with a silver medal.
And I think it really helped. Obviously, she had Ellie Black down on the floor with you. When you've got a teammate there, it kind of settles your nerves a bit more, and you can... It feels more like a team environment, whereas when you're in that individual final and it's just you on your own, it can be a little bit daunting, but she didn't look like she was struggling at all today.
But it was the 18-year-old who stole her thunder, wasn't it? Lu Tingting. And, you know, I remember in 2016 at the Rio Games, there was no individual medalist for China. They were fine in the team competitions, and they really have concentrated really hard on getting up to speed in the individual competitions, and they keep unearthing young talents like this woman.
They do, and it's interesting, because obviously they've been known for picking up bar medals, picking up beam medals, but not so much recently. I think Craig referred to it. They just seem to, when it gets to those finals and that pressurised situation of one-on-one, they just seem to have the small errors. But this routine, to go up last as well, so you're waiting, you've seen everyone else come off, that will put the pressure on you. But she built up a difficulty throughout that routine and didn't struggle with it at all.
And, of course, you don't get a warm-up going into these individual finals, do you? So all the better and all the more impressive. But it's time to hand out some of the prizes. And our first will go in the men's vault. And there's Arthur de la Loyen, just about to go up for his second silver to go with his two golds of this championship. But it is the North Korean, Ri Si-kwang, who comes out for a third time to take the gold here. Alison, Craig, great moment for him.
Oh, it really is. 33 years of age, the reigning Olympic champion, is now the world champion. And yes, for the third time, because he was on top of the podium in 2014 and 2015. Something to be said for experience, Craig.
There certainly has in this field of competition, to be able to perform at that level and considerably higher difficulty vaults than the other two competitors. But I think for me, the man of the moment has got to be Arthur de la Loyen. I mean, just at 22 years of age, the number of medals that he's got in this championship so far, it's almost like the old and the new.
Yeah, he's the one to watch now. Kenzo Shirai, feel for him a little because he came into these championships as holding both floor titles and vault titles. He's had to give them both away. This particular occasion, the vault crown passes from Shirai to this man, to Ri Si-kwang. Well, the master vaulter, two huge vaults here. The Olympic champion becomes world champion for a third time.
Yes, and he hasn't worn that world crown for 4 years, so he's got it back. And there they are, enjoying the spoils. But just outside of the celebrations is Great Britain's Dom Cunningham, because he finished, as you know, 0.09 of a mark off the bronze, which is currently being worn by Kenzo Shirai. So fabulous and frustrating in equal measure for Dom, but he's got to take some real comfort from the fact this is his first World Championship campaign. And let's hear his reaction to his performance today.
Well, Dom, so close, so close. We were all hoping that you would just hang in there at the end, but not quite to be today.
Yeah. I landed my vaults. I'm really happy. This is my first World Championships. Fourth place is possibly the worst place to come. I'm over the moon with my whole championships, and I know I've got more in the bag. I'm going to go back and train, but fourth place, it hurts. But this is the World Championships. The people I'm against are out of... I'm confused. I don't even know that I'm here myself. So being here, I'm just like, let's go. I want more. So this fourth place has made me even more hungry than I was before, and I was hungry before, so...
And you mentioned you can't quite believe that you're here, and a year ago, you know, you were in a very different place. You didn't think you would ever make this, did you?
No, I was ready to quit. This sport was too hard. I was missing out on teams. I was working as hard as I can, and I was missing out. So at the start of this year, I was like, right, one more try. I'm going to try as hard as I can. And now I'm here at the World Championships. I've ticked off what I wanted to do this year, Commonwealths, Europeans, World Championships. And yeah, I'm, like I say, I'm over the moon, and I'm still devastated.
I know you are, but you're a Commonwealth champion, you're a European champion, and you are the fourth best today on the vault in the world. What a year.
You just telling me that I'm fourth in the world has just made me a bit happier, actually, so we'll go with that. But next year, I'm really looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to a nice rest when I get back. Not so much out of the gym, but just to get strong and work on my weak areas and have some fun again. Gymnastics is about fun. I've worked like a robot this year, and it's really, really paid off. And I've done such consistent work out here, and that's what I've never used to be. I never used to be this consistent guy. I used to mess around or fail here, fail there. No one could trust me. But to go out there with no warm-up on the world stage, coming fourth in the world, it is just amazing. Being against people like Rijon Song, who has his actual own vault named after him, they're 33 years old. I'm 23 years old, you know what I mean? I've got a couple more years, and let's go. I want more.
Well, Dom, you mentioned how you've missed out teams in the past. You've been an ever-present this year, and we hope to see you again next year and moving forward to Tokyo. Thanks very much.
Yeah, thank you very much. Come on!
David McDade asking the questions there. And what a character he is. And I have to say, we talked about a poke in the eye for the bullies who teased him about doing gymnastics. There'd be a whole lot of little boys out there saying, I want to be like him. What a fantastic role model, Christian.
Absolutely, and I think that's what it's all about. It's, you know... I think as gymnasts, they try their hardest to raise the profile of the sport. They want to showcase it and show gymnastics in all its glory. And I think we have gymnasts and role models like Dom and the rest of the team that have been doing that and are successfully doing that. And hopefully that will long continue into the future years.
We've talked about how this year, 2018, has been a really full-on year for gymnastics with the Commonwealth Games and for European Championships and now Worlds. But you add it up, 2 golds, 1 silver, 1 bronze and 4th in a world final for Dom Cunningham. That's a breakout year.
It definitely is. I mean, he spoke about it how last year he was not even sure whether to continue because he had struggled so much to make the teams. And this year it's just been incredible. He loves life. He loves gymnastics. So it's great for him.
OK. Another medal ceremony happening right now, and it is in the women's beam. We just watched this. And there is our champion, our new champion, Lu Tingting, just coming out to take the hug from Simone Biles, who settles for the bronze on this occasion, a double world champion in this one, of course. And there's Anna Padarariu, a new name, and I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot more of her on the build-up to Tokyo and a lot more of this young lady as well. Let's savour her moment. Back with Ali and Craig.
A wonderful champion. She kept her composure so well, didn't she? Coming last on the beam, having seen 3 gymnasts before her fall, including some who were expected to be challenging for the podium, but she went clean, she impressed, and at 18 years of age, she's going to have a gold medal around her neck and sort of puts China, Craig, up where they so often have been used to being when it comes to women's gymnastics.
There'll be a real shock in this Games that the Chinese haven't seen as much as what we have done today on the beam, but maybe just that little bit of confidence will put them in the right direction.
And here's the anthem for China.
Champion Lu Tingting of China on the beam, silver goes to Canada's Anne-Marie Padaruru, and the bronze, Simone Biles of the United States.
And it means that Simone Biles is now going for a possible sixth medal in six events. And the last piece will be on the floor. That's coming in one event's time. We've got the men's parallel bar soon. And if she does it, it'll be the first time for a generation. It hasn't been done on the world level since Daniela Silivash at the 1988 Olympic Games in Seoul. Six medals in six events, we'll see. And of course, the floor is her strongest piece, arguably, of the lot. That's coming soon. But we're now on the march, literally, to the parallel bars final, Christian. And this is the piece that's 3.5 metres long, 2 metres high, 42 centimetres apart. And we could see something very special produced on them today. If the Chinese Zhu Jingwan finds his groove today, what really sets him apart from the rest, would you say, at the moment?
I think it is just his execution of the skills, so the way that he performs his routine. And we've probably seen him on the scene a few years ago, and you've seen his routine starting to circle out in social media, and they start to get a bit of a buzz about who this gymnast was. But now he's kind of rise to the occasion, he's performing on the big stage. And if he hits the routine the way that he did in the team final, scoring above 16, I really find it difficult for anybody to be catching that, even Olympic champion Oleg.
We were absolutely agog at this one, Beth, I must say, because this was the highest score of the entire championships. Yeah. Better than Biles, better than anybody. As you say, Christian, 16.2.
Yeah, I mean, literally there is nothing for the judges to take off. His legs are locked together, he holds the handstands. The handstand is a textbook shape. Even when he does the hops, you sometimes see gymnasts just moving their hand placements, which can encourage adduction. But the only big major mistake in the team, I say major, mistake in the team final was his dismount, where he took a small step. So that's where we could see it going even higher than the 16.
Degrees of perfection, isn't it? It's extraordinary, it really is. But I wonder, there's a lot of love in the room, there's a lot of love in gymnastics for a man who has been champion here before, a twice world champion and the reigning Olympic champion. It's Ukraine's Oleg Vernayev. Now, he has really had a tough time of it. He's been having surgery on his shoulder, on the knees. In fact, we can show you the picture of him in the hospital recently. He only came back in September. They have rebuilt him, Christian, I think. But does he have enough right now to unseat Zhu, do you think?
I think it's going to be difficult. I think, you know, I just alluded to, if Zhu does go through, I don't think anyone can touch him, in all honesty. But having said that, you know, for Oleg to still to come back from such big operations, from putting himself back together, and if he does come away from World Championships, to me, that is still a very successful World Championships for him. And as I say, it's going to be difficult, but there's no reason why, even with half a shoulder or one half shoulder, he can't be fighting for the medal still.
Well, actually, he did briefly contend in the all-around for one exciting few moments, I must say, but he kind of ran out of steam on the high bar in the end and was clutching his shoulder a bit, and there was a lot of, oh, I hope he's all right out there. What's your view of him, Beth?
Yeah, I mean, I think he's a fantastic performer. The fact that he's only been back in training such a short period in time and was actually contending in the all-around is incredible. So this is the one piece that we saw him in qualification and the all-around where he seemed to be doing okay. So he's had a rest day. He will have obviously got the shoulder seen too. Seen him posting out on social media, and he was very disappointed with that all-around performance. Just posted a picture of him on the floor after the high bar and saying, "My all-around summed up," and he'll want to kind of turn around his championships here today.
We've also got our old friend Arthur Dalalayan in here going for a fifth medal as well. But, you know, they make it look easy. And I just wonder, in terms of the six pieces of apparatus for the guys, Christian, where does this come in the difficulty rating for you?
I mean, for me, it was always one of the most difficult pieces of apparatus. I didn't particularly enjoy it, but these guys, they excel on it. They're specialists on multiple apparatus. They're able to use their technique, they're able to use their power, the swinging elements, the somersault. So it really is a combination of lots of different acrobatic skills all put together, and all basically it's all relying on good grip as well. So if they can put that good grip in with all the acrobatic elements, then they're in a chance for a medal.
And this, of course, is the piece that poor old Niall Wilson has really scuppered his chances of going to the World Championship. He damaged his tendons just in what would have been a pretty basic move. It just shows you that there's such a fine difference between success and failure, even in training in this event.
Absolutely, and I think that's not just parallel bars, but I think across the board of all apparatus, the scope and the margins for error are so, so minuscule. And it just shows just perhaps a slight lack of concentration, perhaps performing skills when you're slightly more fatigued, then obviously the chance of injury always sort of increases slightly. So we have to be aware of that as gymnasts. You have to make sure that you train properly. You have to make sure you put in the precautions to try and avoid any sort of injuries that might happen from sort of those incidents that you don't really want occurring before a major championships.
Okay, well, there is our start list, and it's Sam Michalak of America who goes once again to try and get that elusive individual medal in a world championship. He's been fourth in high bar in the 2013 Worlds and fourth in the high bar at the Games in Rio, and he dropped from third to fifth in the all-around championship. He's got a couple more chances, and I think, Beth, so many people would love to see this big American finally get his reward.
Yeah, I mean, to be in so many finals and then always just at the last second makes a small error. So he'll be wanting to do that. Obviously, we know he's still got the high bar final today, which probably more chances to make that a medal. But who knows? He's just doing a little bit of a warm-up. You can see the coaches making sure that the chalk is all ready for him. Every gymnast likes it slightly different.
Okay, here we go. It's the parallel bars final. Christian is on his way up to join Craig and Alison in the commentary box. Budge up, guys.
We've made a bit of room. He's on his way. Well, Sam Michalak, and he has just tried and tried, Craig, hasn't he? These world championships, even fourth in the team, missed out on the medal, fifth in the all-around, fourth on the pommels yesterday, seventh on the floor. Now, it would be almost too simplistic to say this bars final is a shootout between Oleg Vanayev, the Olympic champion, and Zhu Jingwang, the world champion, because, of course, there's Arta Dalaloyan up there as well. Does Michalak have the sort of routine that can challenge?
Well, he improved in the all-around competition. However, I think his biggest opportunity this afternoon is on the high bar, finished in silver medal. But it just goes to prove how good an all-round gymnast he is with so many apparatus finals.
Let's see how he goes. First gymnast out of eight to go in the parallel bars final.
Well, this routine's full of originality. Settles himself in. Heely turn. Under somersault there, locking out with straight arms in the half turn. And again, under somersault. That's nice. Height and flighted, the Suarez into the straddle front somersault. It goes into the long hand swing. Very difficult skill. And again, on the Bavzar. So gymnasts must perform elements above and below the rails. Elements in upper arm. And obviously show the handstand position. Big dismount. Double front with a half turn. Oh, I don't think he could have done that any better.
Very nice indeed from Sam Michalak. Terrific way to get this final underway. We've got so used to seeing that beaming smile on his face. Just how much wider could it get if he could come away with a medal?
Well, if it's for determination and commitment, I think he certainly deserves one for this World Championships, because we've seen a real improvement in his work. Look at the height there above the bars. That's the Bavzar skill into the tippelt. Straight into the handstand. He's got a good shape in gymnastics, such he looks quite a tall gymnast. This, the big dismount, but a lot of gymnasts are favouring now the double front somersault. Spots are landing. There you can see the delight. Great start, Michalak.
Well, Christian has joined us in the commentary box. He's such a popular gymnast as well, isn't he, Michalak? And everyone would be so delighted if he could get on the podium.
Oh, definitely. You just watch his reaction. He's always got that smile on his face. It's always a pleasure to be around and competing against. So I think he just gives off that good feeling vibe.
An 8.833 for execution, 15.233. He's 0.2 up on the score he managed in qualifying. So everyone else knows now the benchmark and what they have to beat. We've certainly seen some massive parallel bars scores. You knew we were talking about them in the studio, and Zhu Jingwang, in particular of China, the reigning world champion, hitting the 16 mark
as he did in the team final. But next up is Lin Xiaopan of China, another former world champion. He topped the tree when he was just 18 years old back in 2013. So a competitor that you've been used to moving around the floor with, Christian.
Absolutely. Quite a well-known gymnast now. Been on the international scene for quite a few years.
So second gymnast up on the parallel bars.
You can see all the chalk at the bottom of the parallel bars where gymnast and coach make those final preparations and adjustments to the bars. Make sure the grip is what they need. And there's the Honma skill swing handstand. Well caught there with the straight arms, no hesitation. Into the front uprise door back. Knees jammed together on that skill. And there's the undersummy half turn, hits the handstand again, into the undersummy. Very clean work here. Beautifully into the long swing diamadoff. And into the straddle front somersault. Choosing to catch on the hands rather than the upper arms. And there's the popular Bavsar skill. Probably would be the one skill that every single gymnast in this final will end up choosing to compete. There's the one arm turn, the Healy. Hasn't gave the judges any room for errors so far. And tiniest hop on landings. That was absolutely stunning routine there from Lin Xiaopan.
Well, well. The bar being set high, Craig, with that performance.
Certainly was. I think that was a routine that sort of got better as it went along. For me, that front uprise double back skill at the start, it didn't have the same height and time to kick out as some that we'll see. And parallel bars has become a real piece of apparatus over the past couple of years, which has really sort of developed. Now you can see the starting skill, the front somersault, known as the Honma. And I like this, the front somersault, instead of catching in support, actually catches into the swing underneath the bars. And instead of catching in support, swings through there. If you stay in support, it's the tipelt. And if you're going to long hang swing, the Bavsar. And quite unusual now, the dismount, the double pike back. That used to be a dismount common back in the day, but lots of gymnasts now opt for the double front half turn. What was your dismount, Christian, of
choice?
It
was the double pike. I wasn't quite good enough on the parallel bars to do the double front, or even the double front with a half turn. So I stuck to what I could do best, and just two somersaults in the pike position. That was the highlight of my P-bar routine.
Got to play to your strengths, haven't you?
Absolutely.
Lin Xiaopan, 15.2. Not enough to overtake Sam Mikulac. He can afford one of those familiar smiles. Long way to go, though, in this final. But 15.233 is the score to beat so far. Our next gymnast is from Colombia, Yosimar Orlando Calvo Moreno. Possibly my favorite name in the competition. He's been around a while. This is 7th World Championships. First time in a parallel bars final, though. Let's see what he's got. Qualified in 4th. So Phil, he's got something in the locker to try and challenge.
And a 6-5 difficulty. He posted in qualification. Plenty of height in the opening skill. And that's difficult. Under somersault to one bar, into the Healy turn. So connecting that will give him big difficulty and bonus points. Full turn on one arm, Diamadov. Then the Bavsar skill. Plenty of height and flight above the bar. Travel back into the middle, long swing Diamadov. Into the tipelt. Big dismount, double front with a half turn. These gymnasts do like those double front dismounts. Solid routine, Mikulac looking slightly pensive there.
Has he got good reason to worry, Christian?
I think anybody in this P-bar routine, if they can keep knocking out the routines the way they are, then I think he's going to be pretty anxious and heart rate elevated by the end of this final. But no, that was a very, very clean routine. Again, we're sort of talking here minuscule errors that the judges look for. And there you could see just a slight one where the toes crossed over, whether the judges picked that up at their angles, debatable. For me, not quite as clean as Sam and Lin Xiaopan. Maybe the score might reflect that. I do like this skill though, the long swing, Diamandov locks out into the handstand and then immediately taking it into the tip out. You can see the grimacing on the face as he winds up for the dismount. Knees locked together. And then lands it as well. No movements, knees jammed together, ankles jammed together, nothing to give away to the judges there. Fantastic routine.
Certainly the audience are pleased with that performance. And actually the audience has been quite poor in this championship. It looks like as the competition's gone on, more and more people have got into the venue, which is always better for the gymnasts.
It puts him into the bronze medal position again. Sam Mikulac leading the way, 15.033 for that routine. We've had three gymnasts, three good, strong routines so far. Now can David Belyavsky of Russia put on a score to challenge? Olympic bronze medalist in 2016, world bronze medalist last time out. But it's Sam Mikulac of America who's laid down the marker here.
Definitely David's stronger piece of apparatus. Starts with the under semi. Into the front uprise, Diamandov. The front uprise stood so, so difficult to perform those skills. And there goes into the Bavsar. Changes direction to work back along the parallel bars. Into the Honma skill. That's the skill that most gymnasts opt to start with. There was a slight hand movement there. And another slight hand movement. There's a stutz to one rail. And back to the top again. Just giving away a few deductions here to the judges. Not quite as clean as what I have seen him done in previous competitions, but there's the dismount, done front with a half turn. Just the tiniest hop on landing. Overall, not too bad at all.
Well, he's had a few disappointments, Craig, hasn't he, in this championship so far. Russia were gutted to miss out on the gold in the team competition. He made the pommel horse final, but ended up in seventh with a mistake, big mistake at the start of his routine. So he's got through clear here.
He has, but as Christian picked up, there were a few little hand wobbles. That was should have gone into handstand, which forced him to go into the second skill a little bit too soon. But every time you take a step with the hands, it's 0.1 forwards, 0.1 back. He did that twice in the routine, so that's 0.4. And he has really been the backbone of the Russian team. And you could see, you know, how disappointed he was with the team final, because I think probably that was the one time that he could have been with the team that actually took the world title. So, yeah, I just think he's not been as sharp as we've seen him in the past in this championships. And you can see the look on his face. He doesn't look as happy as normal, Christian.
Yeah, I think you kind of alluded to it. It's not quite as polished these championships as we have seen him.
And it's only good enough for fourth with 14.633. So unable to replicate the 15 plus score that he managed in qualifying. So yeah, the big disappointment in the team event hasn't quite shone as much as he would have liked to in the two individual finals that he's made in apparatus. Two times a European champion on this apparatus. Sorry, one time, 2016, he was the European parallel bars champion. But this man, Oleg Vanayev of Ukraine, is the reigning Olympic champion, 2014 world champion. We have seen his body basically was put back together in hospital a little while ago. He's competing again here and looking to see if he can go for gold.
He'll be chasing his first medal in this world championships. He has a real dominance on this piece of apparatus. Great control there. Under somersault, handstand on one bar. Immediately heely turn. And again, the heely turn out of the three-quarter diamadoff. And the height at which he gets on these moves, the tippelt there. And again. Back in the day, he used to get extra points for virtuosity. He certainly is a virtuoso performer on this piece of apparatus. The studs to one rail, upstart lift to handstand. Big dismount to go. Double front with a half turn. Sticks to landing. Well, that's the Banayev we're used to seeing.
Huge cheers in the arena. You can just see how popular a gymnast he is, how much that routine was appreciated from somebody who has not been off the world podium ever since he took gold in 2014, silvers in 2015 and 17 with that Olympic gold in between. Now, is that good enough to win in that world gold back again?
I think that he will go back into the medal positions with this routine. And to be honest, that's probably as good a routine I've seen him do for, well, as long as I can remember, really. And to the naked eye, I actually think he made a slight mistake in this routine, but covered it up by coming down onto the one rail. So this here, normally he goes back into the two rails, but instead he's had to come down the other way, straddle back up to handstand, which is obviously sapping a little bit more energy. But it just shows the pedigree of what he's on this apparatus. He managed to cover up a mistake, and the judges wouldn't really be taking too many errors or deductions with that skill. So very, very good job there by Oleg.
Well, that really is sort of the mark of a champion, isn't it? If something goes wrong, that you're able to adapt to think quickly in the spur of the moment and either cover it up or just change your routine slightly to still make it work.
It certainly is.
Oh, it is good enough for top spot. Oleg Banayev, the champion, goes into the gold medal position. That's a huge score for him. Delight for Banayev and Ukraine. Three gymnasts still to come. So all about now whether that score can be beaten or not. So Oleg Banayev of Ukraine, 15.591 above Sam Mikulak, chasing that first major medal. And then Lin Xiaopan of China in the bronze medal position. Well, fabulous routine from Banayev. Really showing all his class and pedigree. I think that's a great word to use. Somebody who's won so many medals across both World Olympics and Europeans as well.
To think he's scored a 16 with that routine, I just wonder where they take the deductions.
Now, Zhu Xingwan, the reigning world champion, he doesn't want to give his crown away, has scored a whopping 16 on parallel bars at this championships in the team final. All eyes on him.
Well, if there is someone to top Oleg, this is certainly the gymnast to do it. Beautifully into the McCuts there from the upper arm position. Such difficult skills. You can see just how he locks out in handstand. Beautiful handstand position each time, finishing every skill banging handstand. Lots of height on the long swing. And there's an undersummit half turn, slight back bend there just to readjust. But then straight into the undersummit, no error there. Plenty of height on the straddle front. This really is just incredible gymnastics on the parallel bars. And again, the Bavsar. There's the tippelt. It doesn't even flutter the toes. They're pointed, locked out the whole way through this routine. Incredible. Just the dismount to go. Front uprise into the door front, half turn, nails the landing. That surely has to take that top spot.
Well, that looks like a bundle of pure class, Craig.
Well, I'm going to say that is the most stylish routine of the World Championships. I mean, just the way he floated around the bars and made it look so easy. Even to the final skill, we see the double front performed. Gymnast split the legs a little bit to gain rotation, knees locked together. As Christian said, the height on some of the skills above the bar and the control, all the elements from one bar, he was locked out totally in handstand. I mean, this is a huge skill. The front uprise, three-quarter diamadov, heely turnout, known as the Makut, not even a shuffle in the hands. And again, look at the height there. Straddle front somersault through into the long hang. They posted the only 16 of the competition in the all-around, and probably I think the only 16 we're going to see in this apparatus final. I don't know where the judges took anything off. I mean, look at that, knees and feet together.
You'd like to think that judges will be pretty quick at giving this score out. As you said, that wasn't a lot to take away.
And even the gymnast there showing mass appreciation. I mean, he is just in a different league on the parallel bars.
I think they're in awe. The reigning world champion. I think all of them looking knew that that was an outstanding score. That is massive. 9.433 on execution for a start value of 7. Well, that's got to be deserving of the gold medal. You can't even imagine anyone being able to overtake it. That was outstanding.
6-6 he had in qualification. He put it up to a 7. And we look at that execution of 9.433. I mean, they've given out an award for elegance, but he didn't get it. But in my mind, he should have. That was superb.
Extraordinary from Zhu Xingwan. Two more gymnasts to go, so we're going to see Lukas Dauser of Germany. He qualified last for this particular final, but did take a silver medal on the Europeans last year in parallel bars. Let's see how he goes.
Well, Germany have some pedigree on this piece of apparatus. Marcel Neuen picked up an Olympic silver medal in 2012. But this routine has got lots of originality. Using the upper arm to get bonus in the diamadov and the upper arm skills. Oh, I'm just about to say, good control there. As he put his arm back, dipped the hips, lost momentum. Good swinging in the upper arm position. Double front with the half turn. Well, it's very difficult to follow up a routine like that from Zhu Xingyan of China. And that error, I think, will probably keep him in that eighth spot.
Yeah, it sort of feels that anything else to come is going to be a little bit more low-key someone, how Christian, doesn't it, after we saw that routine from...
Yeah, and I think he did pretty well, actually, initially, to probably block out the score, block out the noise, block out just the sheer appreciation from everybody around those parallel bars. And just, yeah, in awe of the routine they just seen. And he did start off very, very well, actually. He made a similar mistake, actually, in the all-around competition on his heely turns. We might see it again in a minute now where the mistake is. But prior to that, the routine was actually very, very clean. You could see there, didn't quite get his left hand in the catching position he needed. Obviously, coming down with that sort of weight as well, then you have to be so strong and so precise with your hand placement. Just wasn't quite good enough to swing straight away into handstand. And that's the dismount, the ever-popular double front with the half-turn.
I think we've only seen one double pipe back dismount in this final, I think. So it just proves how parallel bars as dismounts are going in a different direction.
13.7 then. Seventh for Dauser with just one gymnast to go. And in the context of this final then, that man surely will take away the gold. But it's a matter of sorting out the medals, and the last gymnast can certainly have a say about that. These are the standings as we have it. Zhu Xingwan with that outstanding, just staggering 16.433. Oleg Vernaev in the silver medal position. And Sam Mikulak in bronze. But looking now, the fact that we have Artur Dalalayan of Russia about to go last, will Sam Mikulak once again be pushed out of the medals? This man has it in him to do a 15-5. He's already won 2 golds and 2 silvers at these World Championships. It's Artur Dalalayan of Russia.
Well, a lot more secure on the start there. That was the error in the team final, but no problem. really does work the bars well. There, the very popular Bavzar. High into the straddle front somersault. This really is a battle for the silver medal. Good control on the Healy turn. Plenty of height and flight in the front somersault. You can hear him big breath for the final dismount. Double front with the half turn. Well, it'd probably be good enough to get a medal, but what colour? We'll see. Mikulak will have to wait.
Drama and tension again. I can barely handle it on, but for the American. But Dalaloyan, he's the reigning European parallel bars champion. Actually did way better in the team final on this, sorry, in the all-around final on this apparatus than he did in qualifying. He really upped his game and came away with that big 15.566.
This is the skill at the start, the clear circle, shoot, half turn, and in the team final, it fell off and lost a full mark. And one of the reasons why the American, the Russians lost the team title. And since then, he's definitely made sure that he's completed that skill.
Well, that's really the only foot he's put wrong through the entire World Championships, isn't it, in that team final? Because since then, as I said, came away with the all-around gold. Gold on the floor as well. We've seen him already today win vault silver. He's still got the high bar final to come. And just almost the story of the championships. He's 22-year-old. Will this bag him another medal?
Two golds, two silvers.
Could be medal number five.
Could well be.
He takes the bronze, 15.366. The world champion is Zhu Jingwan of China. Medal number five in these worlds for that man, Arthur Dalaloyan. And the reigning champion holds on to his crown. A massive, massive score. Sam Mikulak, you feel for him once more. Another final, and it's another fourth place. You can just barely believe it, Craig, for him.
I cannot believe it. He must be thinking, what do I need to do to get a medal? Let's hope on the last piece of apparatus, a high bar, where he qualified second, he picks up that elusive medal, because I'm sure everybody in there will be willing him to win one.
Well, Zhu Jingwan successfully defending his title, and it means China have now had the gold in the world parallel bars for the last three world championships. Arthur Dalaloyan, bronze. Oleg Vanayev, the Olympic champion, takes the silver here. Zhu Jingwan with the gold, and Mikulak missing out once again. But China showing all their strength, Craig, in parallel bars.
They certainly did, and for me, that was the best routine of the championships that have we seen. Fantastic.
It was utterly, utterly mesmerizing, was it not? A fantastic, almost a full mark ahead for Zhu Jingwan of China. Really stylish and incredible to watch. And you could see the respect from the other competitors when he completed his routine. Now, you were talking about the parallel bars, how difficult they are to master. When a gymnast as good as you were and indeed are sees that, what do you think?
I think you're just in awe, to be honest. I mean, I was in awe watching it still. So for the gymnasts in that final with them, I think there's just that mutual respect, there's that appreciation, because they just know how difficult it is to be as good as he is on that parallel bars. And I think it's just clear for everyone to see. I don't think you have to be trained in gymnastics to just appreciate his lines, his execution, his flow to his routine, his technique. Literally, he has got everything on his apparatus. And just to round it off, it's just beautiful to watch.
He is beautiful to watch. And you look at his feet, they're absolutely glued together. It's extraordinary, isn't it? Now, Christian, when you look at a routine like this, which part of the body is it hardest upon, and what is the most pressure? Where does it actually come in the body when you're doing this?
Well, I guess it's a bit of everything, really. I mean, the hands are always in contact with the parallel bars, so I guess from that point of view, you're constantly on your hands, you're always worrying maybe a little bit about the grip, you're always worrying about your hand placements, where they go. But then you also need the speed from swinging down from handstand. You need to create the right shapes, so as he did in that particular skill, the arch into the dish to make the flight above the bars. And then catching as well. You know, there's always a chance of stubbing your finger, as we heard with Niall injuring himself. So it really is a bit of a combination for everything, but it's quite a precise and intricate piece of apparatus. And he just seems to have it down to a T.
And you can see Oleg Pranayev and all the rest of them saying, well, respect, fair enough, fair enough. It had to be done. But there's Sam Mikulac in the background as well. And once again, he's been pipped.
He was in that third medal place right until the last routine. And I think we're literally all cheering him on to try and get a medal. But, I mean, he's still got one more final. So fingers crossed that hopefully he can take a medal in the high bar.
And Arthur Dalalian also has one more final in this high bar as well. And it's not all about Simone Biles at this point, because he's got two golds, two silvers, one bronze, with a chance as well of a sixth medal. This is amazing. We thought Simone Biles was going to completely dominate on an individual basis here, but you must be pretty chuffed that one of the guys is up there as well.
Absolutely, and I don't probably think anyone would have predicted just the championships that he's had. We knew how good he was. I think that's been clear to see from the European Championships that we had early on in the year. But for how he really has just stepped up to the mark at these championships, just been so consistently on such a high level, just banging out his routine one after the next, he really has just been in incredible shape. And so he's got one more final left. We always know that the high bar is the big risk-reward piece of apparatus. Mm. There could be falls, there could be mistakes. So you never know. There's another opportunity for him to win a sixth World Championship medal.
It's quite an interesting story in himself, because he was a bit of a rebel in the Russian team. In fact, he was left off the Rio team because of discipline reasons, and he really started to get himself sorted out thereafter. So it's really only the last 18 months or so we've started to see what he's truly capable of.
Yeah, and he did have a tough time at the beginning of this championships, and it could have gone either way. He could have took that disappointment of falling in the P-bars and going, do you know what, why do I bother? Whereas actually he's gone completely the opposite way. And I think for me, he is the standout male gymnast. Mm-hmm. Obviously he has won the medals, but I just think the character, the personality, the way he's conducted himself at these championships to turn it round from such disappointment to an amazing championship.
They're calling him the new Nemov, Alexei Nemov. And of course, he was the Olympic all-around champion, but in 10 years of competition, he didn't get the all-around title. It's been almost 20 years since the last Russian did that. But of course, we've also got to talk about Oleg Vranayev. And OK, they've rebuilt him, but there's still a bit of tweaking to do on the shoulder there. Great to see that at his advancing age, he's still going to be a force at the next Olympics, yeah?
Absolutely, and I think he probably knew that, and I think this probably just solidifies that in his mind, and perhaps maybe any niggles or worries he might have had post-surgery, going back into a championships, and, you know, are you always going to be the same gymnast after surgery? I guess there's always that doubt in your mind. But he's proved that. We know he wasn't in the shape he needed to be for the all-around, but with time, that's just going to come. It can kind of settle into building himself back properly through rehabilitation. And hopefully then at next year's championships, we'll see him back on the all-around, back fighting for the medals amongst that as well.
Hear, hear. OK. They're going to get ready, the guys, for the high bar final. That's their last piece. But if there's one piece that underscores Simone Biles' dominance, it's got to be her floor work here, Beth. Now, what is it she does, and how much better does she does it than all of the other female gymnasts on this piece then?
Just the difficulty that she's doing. So she's on the first tumble alone, she's doing a double twisting, double straight back, which not many gymnasts could do just into a training environment, let alone perform it on a world stage on the floor area. And then the rest of the routine, we talk about that double twisting, double straight, she then uses that again in a tuck shape at the very end of a routine. Most gymnasts are just pleased to put it as their first tumble. So not only does she put the difficulty in, she keeps the execution high. We have seen her bounding out of the area during this competition, but because she has got such superiority on the difficulty, she's been able to get away with it here in the team final. There's the first tumble that we're talking about, but just bounces out and causes that 0.3 deduction. And here's another big tumble, the full twisting double back. And then this one, is the one that we'd speak about most gymnasts are pleased to do first, and she does it right at the end and doesn't even look like she's run out of energy.
I think that's the point, not even just the energy, but she doesn't look like she's actually pushing her own boundaries. She doesn't look like she's taking any risks out there, Christian. But clearly, these are bigger tumbles than anybody else is even attempting.
Absolutely, and I think, to be honest, she looks like she's enjoying it. She looks like she's having fun out there. She's showing off her incredible talent. She gets to show off just how unique she is on this piece of apparatus. And those skills, as Beth mentioned, they are incredible. And to be doing a double twist in double back at the end of your routine, that's enormous. It really, really is. So I think we just have to be really appreciative of just what she can actually do on the floor. And who knows, maybe she can push those boundaries even further leading into Tokyo as well. So very exciting.
You never know. And I think most people, as we start this final, it's the last for the women, obviously, will be saying, OK, it's going to be gold for Simone Biles. But it could very well be that this lady, Mai Murakami, might have something to say about the silver, at least because she has some wonderful tumbling skills of her own.
She does, and she's the current world champion. Obviously, Simone wasn't there last year, but she's really come into her own. She picked up the silver in the all-around, so she'll be confident and on a high. And she's got some incredible tumbling to watch out for as well.
She does, and here is the lady in question, it's Simone Biles. Remember, she's now going for a sixth medal in six events at these World Championships. She's only ever managed five before in one global championship. There's our fan club in, look at that. We love you, Simone. I think the world loves Simone Biles after what she's been capable of. And we really haven't seen anything like this. If she were to do it, only Daniela Silivas, as I say, at Seoul Olympics, has managed six in six events. Elena Shishunova for the old Soviet Union in 1987 at the World Championship took six medals. But this is 30 years ago we're talking about. And again, it just underlines how much she's changing and indeed elevating the status of women's gymnastics now.
Yeah, and I just think it's great for our sport. You talk about someone like Usain Bolt and people flock to watch him, whereas now that we've got a character very similar to that, people will want to watch our sport. They'll want to tune in and see how she gets on. And the camaraderie between these gymnasts is so nice now.
It certainly is. And those are our finalists. Simone Biles will be going in sixth place today, so she's going to have a chance to watch all of these finalists. And it's the French gymnast Melanie de Santos, Melanie de Jesus de Santos, it's a very long name. We'll get it eventually. And there she is, and she's certainly worth watching. She's a wonderful, wonderful floor worker. In fact, she's the reigning European champion. So this is the last of the six events for Simone Biles, and indeed in the women's gymnastics event. And this sixth, Alison and Craig, is arguably her best.
It is, Hazel. I can't wait to watch the routine and be wowed by it. Mai Murakami will try to challenge as best she can the reigning world floor champion. She won when Simone Biles was taking that sabbatical after the Rio Olympics. Before then, though, she reigned supreme. Three times the world floor champion, back to back in 2013, 14 and 15. And then, of course, the Olympic title at Rio. Bronze already for Biles on the beam today. Murakami here, Craig, at the centre of our picture, is a very stylish gymnast, but just nobody has the difficulty to match, and that's the key.
Well, that seems to be the key, and in the gymnastic community, there's a real split, actually, about the power of Biles compared to the grace, artistry of what was former gymnastics. And I think that's really interesting, that some people love the floor routine, and some people would prefer to see it go back. And people say maybe we should limit it just to three tumbles and you can only do one tumble like this and one at that to narrow that gap. It is personal opinion, but I really do love to see Biles tumble. I do think she pushes the boundaries of sport, and she is a phenomena. You know, it's like saying to Usain Bolt, you're too good, so we're going to tie your shoelaces together. These people come once in a lifetime.
Let these gymnasts fly. The first gymnast on the floor will be hoping to fly, 18 years of age. It is Melanie de Jesus dos Santos of France, the reigning European floor champion. She gets us underway.
So we've seen this gymnast really improve over the last couple of years. And another powerful gymnast, full twisting double back layout. First tumble, couldn't just keep it in the floor. very expressive. Double twist in, double back. Gymnasta told that they must sell the performance to the judges. One, two, double leg spin. And there's a front walk out, straight front, into the double back tuck position. Powerful and expressive gymnast. High into the double pipe back. Well, what a performance from Melanie De Jesus De Santos of France to kick off this world floor final. Beth, what did you make of that?
That is a great way to start this final. I mean, we've seen her earlier in the year at the European Championships winning it, and saw her very disappointed actually during the all-around competition. So she wanted to come out today and obviously perform. She's got some huge tumbling. Here's the first tumble. Unfortunately, I think she just landed outside the floor, so that'll incur a deduction. But some super tumbling here, straight back down the diagonal to do the double twisting, double back, and very little deduction on the error. Chest up, and there's the squat spin. Gymnasts have to show a combination of the leaps and jumps and obviously the difficult tumbling elements. A great routine, very well choreographed.
It's a routine that's also is full of expression and character, isn't it?
It is, and there's the last tumble, the double back. And she looks pleased with it, and we saw her teammates in the audience cheering her on. So she scored a 13.9 in qualification with a 5.6 difficulty.
Can she get up into the 14s in this world final?
Floor is a real difficult piece of apparatus to get above, you know, the high 13s into the 14s, Beth. Takes something really special.
It is, and you can see there she took the 0.3 deduction.
Yep, so 13.433 for De Jesus Dos Santos, the first gymnast. Everybody knows what they've got to beat. They'll all be trying to go clean as well. Don't step out, don't incur any penalties. And Flavia Saraiva of Brazil is next to go. 19 years of age on floor. I saw her at the Rio Olympics for Brazil. Very popular routine there.
Yeah, she was definitely a home favourite during those Olympic Games in Rio. Unfortunately, she had a year of injury last year, but great to see her back. There's the big opening tumble, but unfortunately that step out will incur the 0.1 deduction. Here's the leaps and jumps. Great amplitude on those. Here's another big tumble. There's the double straight. Gymnasts have to show two leaps linked together. Most gymnasts opt to use four tumbles. That was her third, the 1.5 straight into a full twist. And now a bit of time to show off the choreography. Great spin. And builds up to the final tumble. Gets the crowd going in the background. For a gymnast, it always feels so good to have the crowd clapping along to your routine. And there's the big last tumble, the double pike. Covers up the landing.
Well, a real crowd favourite, you have to say, Beth.
Definitely there. You can see her teammates cheering her on in the crowd.
Well, a real star of the Brazilian team. And it was jam-packed from start to finish. And what always amazes me is how the judges determine, you know, the marks for artistry, musicality. The gymnasts have got to interpret the music. Yeah, it was creative. It was expressive. That's the first opening tumble, the step out. So 1 foot is 0.1. And she definitely uses all the floor, and she's such a powerful gymnast. That's the double straight position, and the judges can deduct that separation in the legs. But she jumps so high in the leaps and showing great flexibility. And the combination, 1.5 twist into the straight front full. Forward somersault now one of the requirements. And then, no problem, lifting up into the double pike.
So the Brazilians have brought in a new head coach, Valeri Lukin, who is father and personal coach to Nastia Lukin.
Well, he'll be pleased to see that score, 13.766. Well, it puts her above De Jesus after she had her 0.3 penalty. Not quite as strong as she managed in qualifying, however. But do you believe he's made a real difference to the Brazilian team?
I think he has. He'll bring over the next couple of years leading into Tokyo. We already saw them in qualification come high up the team rankings. Unfortunately, they just had a bit of a disaster on the bars at the last piece and pulled them right down.
Well, we've seen one medal for Canada today on beam. Brooklyn Moores here now competing on floor.
Canada have really impressed at these championships. Scored well in qualification leading into the team final. Picked up a medal in vault final yesterday. And there we are, a big first tumble straight front into the double front, but a big deduction on that landing, did well to hold it. A very different style of routine. Uses a lot of the forward tumbling elements, the double front with a half turn. Nice spin. Great leg separation in those jumps. Gymnasts have really been working on the artistry over the past few years, and we've seen a lot of very good choreographed routines. Here she builds up for another big tumble. The 2.5 into the full twist and just staggers out.
Well, plenty of artistry, you're right, in that routine. But we're really in a battle for silver and bronze behind what we know Simone Biles can do in terms of what she packs in and the difficulty that she sets way beyond everybody else. Craig, what did you make of that one?
Well, it was certainly different from the first two routines in terms of the pace of the routine, and that was a big contrast for me. It was very balletic, you know, in terms of just not the same power around the floor. She went for a very big first tumble, handspring and a connection into the double front somersault, and if you don't get the timing right on takeoff, there's very little you can do, and she did well actually to recover that and not sit back down. There you can see, double front somersault with the half turn, chest down a little bit, and that will be deducted because judges are looking for the chest being right up facing the direction you've come from. And she did look like a little ballerina in one of those little jewellery boxes I didn't have one of those as a child, but my sister did. So, it was a real contrast in the routine. Probably not the difficulty that we're going to see and I think she might struggle in this field to, you know, pick up a medal with those errors as well.
We saw her in the fourth final in Montreal and managed fifth in that final. She qualified down in eighth. Gymnasts always want to try and improve on the years before. She'd been hoping to be challenging for podium, but we've got a lot of class gymnasts and some of the best ones to come yet in this floor final.
We have, and obviously it's interesting, most gymnasts you'll see use four big tumbles. She opted just to use the three tumbles and uses a lot more of the jumps and leaps. Here you can see very well kind of interpretation of the, very good interpretation of the music.
And that is still important as far as the judging goes, isn't it?
It does, the judges can deduct for artistry awards, so they have really been trying to encourage more artistry back into these gymnast routines.
Well, a score of 13.066 puts a third of the three gymnasts we've seen to go so far. But we've got a number of routines still to come, which all have much higher start values, much higher difficulty. And this is one of them. We'll see a little bit of wow factor from Mai Murakami, who's the reigning world floor champion. She won gold in the absence of Simone Biles. And she was having a sabbatical in 2017. All around silver in these championships. Here she goes on floor.
And we're going to see huge, powerful tumbles from this gymnast. Had a great all-around championships at this competition. Had a bit of a trouble with this first spin. Just fell out of it a bit too early today as well. Here we are, the double twisting, double back. Not a flicker on that one. Head straight back down the diagonal, using the double straight, just a small hop back. Here we are with the 2.5 twist into the full twist, built up the connection by linking the two twisting somersaults together. Now has to show off the routine and incorporate the jumps and leaps. Another big spin, the double leg spin up. And the final big tumble, you can hear the buzzer going. There's the double pike.
Well, a very different sort of routine to what we saw before, wasn't it? Expressive, but also much more dynamic.
It certainly was, and she's one of my favourite all-around gymnasts in the world at the moment. And really packs a punch on the floor. She's got some big tumbles, like you say, very expressive, creative as well with some of the dance moves. Like you say, a little bit different, but that's what we need. And I think that was one of the better floor routines we've seen in this championships. This is very difficult to be able to spin, there you go, and loses out. That's what happened, actually, in the all-around competition. She came off floor in floods of tears, thinking she'd actually blown all chances of a medal and ended up with a silver medal in that all-round competition.
That was also Japan's first medal in the world all-around since 2009 as well, so as well as being a world floor champion, that's made plenty of headlines in Japan for getting on the podium in the all-around.
Well, I imagine the women's side of gymnastics in Japan has taken a bit of a back seat to the men's success over the years, and I think this gymnast will be really carving out women's gymnastics in Japan. A trailblazer, a bit like you, Brett.
As a world champion yourself on this apparatus, Beth, can you appreciate what it's like to stand on the floor as a world champion? And that does put her into top spot. 13.866 for Mai Murakami. Oh, that look of steely determination says, yep, I knew I could put in a routine to go top.
Yeah, I mean, she knew when she came off. There was a couple, the tumbles there was not an issue with at all. It was just a couple of the coming out of the spins. So she'll just have to sit and wait it out now. We've got a few big names still to come.
Angelina Melnikova.
And Angelina Melnikova is European champion on this apparatus in 2017.
The level of difficulty that these gymnasts are performing now is incredible. There's a very nice spin to start the routine. She's going to open with a big tumble. There's the full twisting double straight inside the floor area. And there's the jumps and leaps that she needs to show. Straight into another big tumble, packs in the difficulty. The double straight. A very expressive routine. There's the triple squat spin. Built up to the third tumble, the front summy walkout into the double tuck. All the gymnasts have to show a front somersault in their routines in the tumbling pass. Double leg spin up. Just has one more test to finish this routine off. And there it is, the double pike, a small hop forward. But one of the cleanest routines we've seen so far.
Highly polished from the Russian, very impressive indeed.
Well, the first apparatus final for Melnikova in this World Championships, and she's promised so much over the past year or so and failed to deliver, but for me, that was the best floor performance we've seen so far. She posted a 14.033 in qualification, so if she can match that, she could take the lead. And so graceful and elegant to watch. And also, I think she has the right mix. She has the powerful tumbles. I mean, that's a big first tumble, double straight with the full twist, but then the grace and beauty of the choreography. For me, best routine so far.
See the landings. Here's the triple squat spin. Just got it round, but should get credited it.
It always looks a difficult spin to get into that, Beth, down onto the floor, and then try and get out elegantly. You know, you sat down on the floor and getting back up, that's the hardest part.
Definitely have to get the choreography to kind of use the choreography to get into the spin, and then use the choreography to get out of the spin as well.
Oh, that's an anxious looking face, isn't it?
Judges are taking a long time to get these scores out.
Well, she struggled staying in the floor in the all around. I think she had a hop out on that big opening tumble. So that's a tenth better.
You know. So much adrenaline coursing through you, isn't it?
When you of course.
Take to the floor in a final. You've been seeing Simone Biles bounce out.
And certainly the Russian women have not performed half as good as the men in this competition.
It puts her into the silver medal position. 13.8. 3-3. Well, Mai Murakami still sits above her. Simone Biles is to come.
Interesting, they had the start value down at 5-7. But there's confirmation of the standing so far. Murakami leads over Melnikova. And Sarajeva of Brazil sits in third.
Well, that's the battle for silver and bronze, really. Mai Murakami leading the way. Simone Biles is head and shoulders above the pack. The Olympic champion, the three-time world floor champion. She already has 13 World gold to her name. She's got some pretty young fans in as well. That is a look of composure and determination to just come out and do what she does. It's a routine where you can just sit back, enjoy and be wowed. If she can keep herself in control. You said, just saw a bit of that excitement burst in where she bounced out of the floor earlier on in the championships.
I think that's going to be the hardest part for her, is controlling that energy. She's so powerful, and the floor that they're using now has got a lot of spring in it. So for a lot of the gymnasts, if you don't control that landing, it will recoil back at you. And obviously we know Simone is very, very bouncy. She's got lots and lots of fans in supporting her today.
Judges are making her wait here though.
Yeah, I'm not too sure why, because the scores come in from the previous gymnast. If an inquiry had gone in, that wouldn't affect the rest of the competition going ahead. So
here we go.
From the USA, Simone Biles.
And she's going for her sixth medal at these World Championships. And what would be a 14th career gold in all.
So this is the first of the four big tumbles. Here it is, the double twisting, double straight. Takes a step back, but clearly inside the floor area. A great start to this gold medal routine, hopefully. Straight back down the diagonal with the skill that she's known for, the double straight with a half turn, rebounding into a jump. Now she's got a bit of time to do the jumps and leaps. Has to show the front somersault, so there it is. Into the full twisting double back and takes a step out of the floor. That'll incur the deduction. She is well ahead on the difficulty. Audience are getting involved in this routine now. There's the double squat spin. Huge height and amplitude on these leaps. And builds up for the final tumble. Uses the double twisting, double tuck. And just is fully up. What a fantastic way to finish her championships and probably take that 14th world title.
Gymnastics at its most spectacular. Well, she took her 13th career gold on vault, a year to the day that she returned to the gym after that sabbatical after the Rio Olympics. She already has more world golds to her name than any other gymnast in history, and she's surely going to add to that tally here.
Certainly was. That was a performance and a half. The first tumble was absolutely stratospheric. Double straight with the double twist. This is the one she bounced out of the floor in the all around, stayed in there, no problem whatsoever. Then goes back. This is the Biles, the double straight with the half turn, connects immediately into the leap, so that eliminates any chance of a landing deduction. As Beth said, gymnast must do a straight front somersault with a full twist, and there into full twisting double back, and she just jumps back, and whether it's 2 feet out the floor, just one. So that's point one. But yeah, without doubt, the floor routine to beat. And something she's improved on, her flexibility and the height and the jumps when she does the leaps has definitely improved. But you can see her demeanour is totally different when it's on this. She's on this piece of apparatus. She doesn't look anxious, agitated at all. Where when she goes to the beam, she looks a little bit uncomfortable at the minute. But here, where she can really relax and put on a performance.
And she is utterly, utterly at home on this piece of apparatus. We're hearing that an inquiry was rejected for Angelina Melnikova on floor. But Super Simone Biles, 14.933. She doesn't know it yet. There's a penalty of 0.3. And that score can't have come up in the arena just yet. Now it has. Biles shoots to the top. She looks cool as a cucumber. Just another day in the arena. It will be a sixth medal for Simone Biles at these single world championships. She's Super Simone. She does staggering gymnastics.
They're discussing the step out. I think their coach has come in to discuss, was it? We thought it was 1 foot, but I think because she took her other foot off now the floor, whether they think exercise, take that as 2 feet being out.
Morgan Hurd. Well, Morgan Hurd, an exciting gymnast from the USA. Bronze in the all around.
Was a great opening double, the double twisting, double tuck. And here we are, the double straight just piked it down at the end. There's the change leg ring into the 1.5 turn splits. Each gymnast has their very own style. Can see Simone in the background cheering her on. There's the full twist out of the straight front. Another jump to build up the difficulty. Has just one more tumble to finish her world championships off. And there's the double pike and just a small hop back.
Now, very neat looking performance from Morgan Hurd. We saw her in the bars final yesterday for the USA, came sixth then. It's the first time competing in a world floor final though, and she really held her composure well, didn't seem to be awed by the occasion at all.
No, I think they've got so much competition experience. Every national championships that they perform at, they have podiums, they have huge crowds.
She lost out her world all-around title from last year, went to Simone Biles. So she is a gymnast who excels across all four pieces. And you're right, the USA gymnast, just look at that focus.
She looked like she was having a big yawn then from this angle. But I can assure she wasn't far from sleeping. In that routine, big opening tumble, double twisting, double back. That's the skill that for Biles finishes with the final tumble. And you can see double layout as well. Beth pointed out chest down just a little bit there. I mean, that's just minute. Combination tumble, straight front in the full twist. So that's one of the requirements in the women's code on the floor. So it's real tight at the top, actually, for silver and bronze, Ali.
Well, that's the battle we knew was going to be on.
And the Cova obviously put in an appeal. I had a difficulty at 5.9.
Oh, it's good enough to go into the silver medal position. Huge celebration from Simone Biles, her senior in the US team. Well, we could have a US 1-2. There's one more gymnast still to come. But it's Simone Biles leading ahead of Morgan Hurd by a whole mark. And even with those 0.3 that Simone Biles was penalised, it just shows how far ahead she is with the difficulty of her floor routine. But Mai Murakami, who was the world champion, is down in the bronze medal position. And this is the last gymnast to go from Russia. Lilia Akhaimova is now taking to the floor to round off
these Women's World Championships.
He came into this competition in the Russian team as a floor and vault specialist. Full twist in double back straight. Not the height. Had to take a big stagger forwards. A little bit better there on the double layout. Well controlled on the double spin. Quite dramatic floor music. Gymnasts allowed to pick their own music. The double Arabian. Good control on the single leg spin. Before the final tumble, stands up, full twisting double bike. Well, saved the best landing to last. Lilia Akimova of Russia finishes this women's floor final.
Well, we saw some errors early on from gymnasts stepping out of bounds. Competitions got cleaner as we worked our way through it, really. But a gymnast there in her first world final. Of course, wowed in between by the performances of Simone Biles. Yeah, she qualified in seventh place. Her start value in qualifying, 5.7. They're not quite up there with those who are currently in the medal places, depending on how clean she can manage to score here.
Well, I think the deduction on that first tumble we've just seen there, the full twisting double back straight, was that low and had to stagger forward, chest down. She had a chest down on the double straight and that step forward. I don't think it will change the top three. But it's currently Biles, Hurd and Murakami. That was a better landing, full twisting double back.
Well, how will the judges score this one? Will there be any change in the top three?
Well, she only posted a 5-1 difficulty in qualification. You can see the look of disappointment at Melnikova. If that inquiry would have been accepted, it would have put her into that bronze medal position. So it's well worth submitting an inquiry if you think you have got a point to prove. Yeah.
And if your federation will pay for it.
Well, this is true.
So a bit of a wait before the final scores are confirmed. So seventh place for Akimova. It's another gold for Simone Biles. She confirms her status as just the best gymnast the world has seen. Disappointment for so many others who miss out on medals. A distraught Melnikova, but a delighted Simone Biles. Six medals in these World Championships alone. It's her fourth gold here, her 14th career gold in all. And Mai Murakami, oh, she's smiling despite losing her world title now to Simone Biles. She comes away with the bronze medal. But Biles really head and shoulders above the rest on floor. It is her piece of apparatus. Champion in 2013, 14, 15, Olympic champion in 16. She only lets the others have a look in when she decides to take a break. But a year out and a year since she returned to training, she's come back and taken these World Championships by storm. Her fans love it. We love watching it. She is surpassing all other gymnasts that have gone before her. A record 14th career gold, extending her legend. Biles from Hurd with silver, Mai Murakami with the bronze, and a huge disappointment for Angelina Melnikova, missing out on a medal, fourth for her. But again, it's Super Simone finishing these World Championships with yet another gold medal.
She's done it, you're absolutely right, Alison. Six events, six medals. We've been keeping count of them, obviously. And right now, if Simone Biles were a country, she would be top of the medal table in Doha, which is extraordinary, isn't it? Four golds, one silver, one bronze, with a kidney stone and a visit to A&E the night before the championship started. My goodness, once she's healthy, she's certainly going to turn up some trees, isn't she? She's at the absolute height of her powers. And it was height and power that was the key to that routine too.
It was. I mean, we've seen her a bit nervy on a couple of the other apparatus, but when she comes onto that one, she just comes into her own. She shows off her personality. And I mean, those tumbles are just incredible. The difficulty that she is putting out with only having been back in competition less than a year is just amazing. I mean, I think we're going to see the first tumble here. And I mean, this, I saw her first compete it back in, I think it was June, July, and she looked a little bit anxious about competing it. She had a mat in place, but now she just looks like it's second nature to her. And this second tumble, which she's the only person in the world to perform it like that, and you can see her coach in the background.
Well, that is the Biles, named after her. And Christian and I were talking whilst watching that. And that's a move that even some of the guys would think twice about attempting, yeah?
Well, yeah, I think it's probably quite a scary landing, actually, because obviously you can't spot the floor. There's quite easily, with the extra adrenaline, you're a bit higher, you could potentially land on straighter, stiffer legs, which is obviously very dangerous. So it is, you know, it's one of those tumbles which would be quite scary to do and quite daunting, I should imagine. But the fact that, you know, she gets the height in a tumble, she gets the rotation, the technique is very, very good as well, and she's consistently putting those sort of skills together. And I think all with that, it's you know, it's a recipe for the routine that she gives you.
It's extraordinary. And, you know, you mentioned her coach, Lauren Landy, actually, who said the other day, champions like this come along just once in 100 years. In all events, other than the uneven bars, we're raising her level of gymnastics to a point that it's getting crazy to almost think she can do harder skills. So we're really going to have to work on her consistency, because where she is right now, it is humanly almost impossible for her to raise the bar higher. That's an amazing thing to hear.
It is, and I think we've seen that inconsistency come through, whether it is down to the level of difficulty she's performing or whether it's down to the fact that she's not been back in competition very long. We'll see that next year. So she's got a big decision to make leading into Tokyo. Do I go more consistent and stick with the level of difficulty I've got now, or do I try and increase that difficulty?
Well, she's got these decisions to make, but let's just let her enjoy the moment for the time
being.
And we're going to enjoy the last event in these World Championships. It is, of course, the spectacular men's high bar. Such showmanship, such skill, usually from a certain Epke Zonderland, everybody's favourite male gymnast at the moment. And he's produced some amazing things. Everybody remembers 2012 to win the gold at the London Olympics. But this last year, Montreal, to literally hang on to a silver medal, a one-handed catch. Now, you remember this, Christian. In the list of what you've seen, how remarkable a moment was this?
Oh, it's just incredible. I think 95% of gymnasts would have pinged off, ended up landing on top of a judge or in the crowd or in a heap on the floor. And to have that sort of grip strength to be able to just swing around from catching a big release. You know, you're catching that bar up multiple times around body weight on the one hand really is quite incredible. And then to have that composure just to carry on so casually with the rest of your routine.
Well, here it comes. This was extraordinary. And there was a huge intake of breath in this Montreal arena when it actually happened. And we saw so many people just stunned at how he was able to hang on to that. Now, he's going for a fourth world title here. No one's ever done that. Why is he such a charismatic and such a popular figure? Because he's now known as the Flying Dutch Doctor.
I think because of the difficulty and the risk element that he has there. I mean, you can see even his own teammates were kind of like, what is he doing? And I think Christian said it very right. Most gymnasts would have pung off that bar, but he's building up difficulty, linking elements that no one else would even dream of.
Well, we'll see whether he can do it today. But Kohei Uchimura, actually, King Willem actually was there. And that's his reaction. He could hardly look. that's the level of support he's got. But if not Ipke, might it be Kohei Uchimura of Japan, who's been so upstaged in these championships, obviously, with these double ankle injuries he's been nursing. He's hardly been seen apart from in the team competition. Will he muscle his way into the headlines at the very last minute for you, Christian?
I'd like to hope so. I think he quietly, confidently has probably still gone about his business, and you know, he qualified top, and I'm pretty sure a clean routine is going to get him in the medals.
OK, so here we go. It's the men's high bar. Truly awesome event. So sit back and watch in wonder with Craig and Alistair.
This is the spectacle of all spectacles, the finale of the World Championships. And the first gymnast of the eight to go is from Chinese Taipei, Tang Chia-Hung, Craig.
Well, I took a gold in the Asian Games. On this piece of apparatus, plenty of flight over the top of the bar. The Markalov has got another big release coming. Full twisting Kovacs had to catch a little bit close, and that bent arm on the long swing will be costly. That's better. Straight Katchev, straddle Katchev, straddle Katchev, off turn. So the release and catches in combination will add bonus points. It's a really difficult piece of apparatus to get a good e-score on. Any turns that should be in handstand that go past will be deducted, but a good solid dismount. Double twisting, double straight. Qualified down in seventh, so he'll be wanting to maybe improve a little bit on his qualification score.
Well, the first routine then is a clean one. High bar can be a little bit like, you know, pommels, where if you see one gymnast fall, it can sort of send a bit of a ripple effect through the rest of the gymnasts still to come.
And for me, that was probably the worst part of the routine. On the full twisting Kovacs, he caught a little bit too close, and then he had to bend his arms on the long swing. It was much better in the other release and catch skills. The coaches, you know, spend a lot of time with their gymnasts trying to perfect and hone their skills. And that's what the judges are looking for also. Straight arms, turns into and around the handstand.
Well, 14-2 in qualifying. Managed a 14.725 at the Asian Games when he won gold, and actually beat Zhao Ruteng into bronze. Now Zhao Ruteng is the fourth gymnast to go in this final. Tremendous all-around worker, Zhao Ruteng. So this is a very promising performance from a promising and high-class gymnast in this world final. It's a horrible wait, waiting for that score.
They seem to have taken the time to get some of the scores out in these apparatus finals. Just wanted to make sure they get the scores right and the gymnasts in the right order.
Well, that's better than he managed in qualifying. 14.266. That's the score everybody else now needs to beat. Christian Thomas has joined us in the commentary box. Christian, seen you in many a high bar final over the years. But this man, Ipke Zonderland, two-time world champion, the reigning Olympic champion in 2012, two-time European champion as well. But as we saw in the build-up, he's had his moments of drama.
So Ipke has got multiple choices for his routine, the way he chooses to connect some of the skills, and a lot of them, I think he makes the decision based on how he catches his previous skill. There's the Xena, immediate into the Kovac, beautifully caught then. And then there's a Coleman into the Gaylord, which is over the top with a half turn. Beautiful release catch, probably one of the best I've actually ever seen him do. There's a squat half, followed by the squat full, into the squat half. And there's just the dismount left. Builds up into the double twisting, double straight. Nails the landing. Incredible work there by Ipke Zonderland.
Wow, that was a high bar at its best. A champion's performance. Zonderland is just spectacular. And that wowed the crowd, as it also wowed the judges.
You can see why he's a flying Dutchman, or the flying doctor now. So the full twisting straight corebacks into the corebacks linked. So big skills. And that was the second corebacks into the gearload skill. The back somersault with the half turn over the bar to swing out. For me, the worst part of the routine is the in bar work. The squat dislocate with full turn. It's got to be as close to handstand as possible. And then again with the squat this low half. And I don't know your thoughts on that, Christian, but to me, there were the bits where he could pick up some serious deductions.
Yeah, I think he did sort of miss the handstand on the squat full and squat half. To be honest, I think I'll forgive him for the work he did previously to that. But I should imagine if you've just done those four massive releases, how hard it is to kind of compose yourself, bring yourself back down a little bit for such an intricate in-bar element. I should imagine it's very, very difficult to do. But as I say, the those releases were just out of this world. They really were beautifully performed.
And like you say, he's a gymnast. It's so aware of where his body is and where he catches the bar. And as we all know, if you catch a little bit too close, it's very difficult to put the second release on. So you have to make that split decision. Am I going to put another one on or am I just going to take an extra swing? And he obviously hit it there, no problem whatsoever, and finished well. Big dismount, double twisting, double back. It'll certainly put the pressure on the rest of the finalists.
Yeah, brilliant landing on dismount. He's a very special gymnast. And you mentioned the flying doctor. He's, of course, been doing medical studies alongside his gymnast career. Finally finished his degree, so he is a doctor. 15.1, massive from Zonderland. 6.8 to go with an 8.3. Now that sends out a big message to the rest. Is anyone going to be able to better it? That's a huge start early on in the competition.
Well, he upped his difficulty. 6 tenths from qualification. So he's certainly thought about changing the routine.
And he's doing all this at 32 as well. And he's aiming for Tokyo, isn't he? 2020.
Oh, I think it's just incredible, really, when you kind of break it down to what he's actually achieved already and what he still is going on to achieve. It's it's nothing short of incredible.
Well, this story continues, doesn't it? Sam Mikulak of the USA still in the final piece of apparatus at these World Championships, still looking to try and get that first ever major medal.
Well, is that first medal within his grasp? He's got lots of originality. Full twist there, no problem. Come on, Sam. And again, in the tuck position. He qualified second on this piece of apparatus. He's got real variety. Straight catch him. Straddle catch him. And combines with the half turn. Intricate full turn on the one arm. Squat half. Hop full. Stolder. Come on, winds up for the big dismount. Double twisting, double back. Little adjustment on landing, well. I hope that's good enough, because if anybody deserves a medal in this competition, it is the mighty Mikulak.
It really doesn't feel like he's done much wrong these championships. We see him time and time again, Christian, in these individual apparatus finals, and indeed in the all-around. He finished the routine, the beaming smile. You think, yeah, he's done a good job, and then he gets pipped.
That does seem to be a recurring theme for him, but I'm not going to put myself out and say he'll get a medal on that, but that was a very, very clean routine. I really like the way that he actually performs his Kovacs element, so neat and tidy, and the way that he catches and then he links straight away into the giant to wind up for the next Kovacs. I think he's a very, very clean gymnast, and he really hasn't given a lot away for the judges on these release elements. And there's the... This is where he connects the two catch of elements together. There's the catch of into the straddle catch of with the half turn. Legs jammed together. So who knows? Maybe this is the one to break that that world championship duck that he's been after for a while.
He's had 3 fourth place finishes at these championships alone. Fourth in the team, fourth on pommels, fourth early today on parallel bars. He's had a fifth in the all around, and he came seventh on floor. But we heard Dom Cunningham with his fourth place in vault for Great Britain early just say, oh, it's just the worst place to finish. Even though he's fourth best in the world,
but for Mikki Latkin, he's been competing at so many more world championships, it's good enough for silver at this stage. 14.533. Yes, he says, I'm up there for now. But we've still got five gymnasts to come. We've still got Kohei Uchimura to come. We've got the defending world champion still to come. We've got Arta Dalaloyan of Russia. He's going to go last as well. We've also got Zhao Ruteng of China. Team gold all around silver so far. Pommel horse gold as well in these championships. So it's the fourth man to go in this high bar final.
From China, Zhao Ruteng.
So last routine for Zhao Ruteng. Obviously had the very successful championships. A nice way to cap it off here with a medal. First release element winding up now. There's catch up with the full turn. Call the looking. Cleanly caught. And into the second release. There's a strike catch-up. Had to catch slightly close to the bar. And there's the straddle. And then into the straddle half element. I think when you compare this, the catcher releases perhaps to Sami Kulak, I would have to say that Sam definitely had more height and was the cleaner catch. And there's the squat half element again, missing handstand there. Similar to his squat full turn. Winds up for the dismount. Double twist in double strike. Sticks the lancer, a great way to finish off his routine.
Yeah, very strong finish to the routine, Craig. What about everything that went before it?
Well, I have to agree with Christian there. For me, it just didn't have the extra virtuosity, the height on the releases to Mikulak. And yet again, for me, the squat into the bar where they do the full turn and the half turn. The first squat dislocal was really late. And then the second one, we can allow him a little bit of tolerance maybe for a full turn, but that half turn should really go into handstand. And he was way past. So he had a 6-1 difficulty in qualification, which was Mikulak's. So I would be really disappointed for Mikulak if, you know, he wasn't still in front. And that's the straight catcher, full twist, the looking. I remember one of your skills, Christian.
It was indeed.
And the bar is 2.6 metres above the mat.
See, this is the first one I was on about the full turn. Before he got his hand on, it was really late. He had to adjust his arm, bend a little bit. There, the Markelov. Could be doing a bit straighter in the body as well and not the same height over the bar and catching on that bent arm. But good finish. Strong.
Double twisting, double straight. Dismount. Visually.
Yep, the stuck landing will please the judges.
He's satisfied.
It's been a great all-round competition for him, hasn't it, these World Championships?
Well, he's still smiling. So that's always a good sign. Look at Mikulak there.
Fourth place, no medal for Zhao Ruteng on the high bar. So 13.9. Epke Zonderland still leads the way with that huge 15.1. Now this gymnast is the defending world champion. And by winning in Montreal, he became Croatia's first ever world champion, which is an extraordinary story in itself. He says Croatia only have one gym, it's in Zagreb, and there's no pits to even train high bar on. They train with hard landings.
That's why you don't fall off the bar.
Best way to train in that case. Here we go, the defending champion.
Straight into the Healy turn. Stoller into the catch-up, very unusual, connects another catch-up, and a straight catch-up, and another. Four catches together. So difficult. Squat half turn. Into the straight catch up with a half turn. A lot better with the stoop full. And into the heel it. Working well so far. Just needs a good solid dismount. winds up, full twisting double back straight. Well, he's happy with that.
Well, some extremely impressive parts of that routine, Christian. I mean, those four catch-ups in a row to start with. Why is that so difficult to keep linking them repeatedly like that?
Well, I guess the main reason is depend on how you catch that first release will then depend on the second depends on the third on the fourth, and very unique actually. You don't see many gymnasts now nowadays competing so many releasing elements, but it's actually quite a nice way to minimise the deductions. It's a nice way to spend less time on the bar. Here's the first one, there's the stole the catch-up, sorry. Immediately into the straddle catch-up, now into the straight catch-up, and then into the straddle half-turn catch-up. So you could start to see running slightly out of steam towards the end, but very, very impressive combinations there. And again, that little bit unique as well, and perhaps that plays on the judges' mind a bit, the fact that he's doing something different, something that the judges haven't seen regularly, so they're not naturally going to take the 0.1, 0.2 that they might do watching other skills, because they haven't seen them so regularly, they haven't judged them so regularly. So a good way of standing out, I guess, more than anything.
And we often see the stolen catch-up performed by the women on the uneven bars. I don't know your thoughts, but for me, that routine is just a little bit one-sided around the catch-ups. I'd like to see Kovacs catch-ups, a variety of releases. But that is very, very difficult to put four together like that. And that builds the difficulty as well.
Oh, a bit hard to read the faces of these gymnasts as we watch them on the side of the floor. Okay, Zonlad also became a father since Rio as well. So life's taken a slightly different turn for him since the Olympics.
He'll have to go back with the gold medal, otherwise he'll be in the bad books.
But Cervic, the defending champion, he's 22.
Here's the score.
Here we go. Can he beat 15.1? 14.5, he is in amongst the medals. As is Sam Mikulac still. Mikulac still in the silver medal position. He looks relieved. He looked as if he wasn't quite sure how that was going to score. Here's confirmation then of how we stand with three gymnasts still to go. It is Epke Zonderland looking for a third world title. Fourth world global title in all if you count his Olympic title. But Sam Mikulac is going to be waiting and watching to see what happens with Deng Shudi, who's the next gymnast to go. At Zonderland, he'll be a massively popular winner if he takes the gold. But Deng Shudi of China, 27.
I have to say, I think the Chinese over the last few years have improved drastically on this piece of apparatus. I think it was always perhaps one of their weaker areas. I don't think aesthetically they looked quite as good as perhaps some of the other countries, relevant of some of the global medals that they did win from Zhu Kai and Cheng Long, people like that. But they have improved, and that's one of them. Straight catch-up into the straight catch-up half turn. Jams the squat half into handstand. And then again connects the straddle catch-up into the straddle half. Slight pause. But very nice squat full there, nice and controlled. And there's the one-arm turn from the endo Healy. That's his fifth release, the Marklov, which is release over the top of the bar. Slight hand adjustment there. Winds up for the dismount, double twist and double straight. And the hop forward, good solid performance there from Deng Shudi.
Does he have the complexity? Does he have the difficulty to be challenging for medals?
Well, he might challenge for a medal, but I don't think it'll challenge Zonderland. Interesting, he's only apparatus final in this World Championships. And as Christine said, I think this is a piece of apparatus China's obviously gone back to the drawing board and worked on, because it was one of their weaker pieces. And now to see two Chinese gymnasts in this high bar final just proves that the hard work is paying off. And really did make use of the catch-up. Yeah, straight catch-up with the half turn. And there's only one of the hesitations. This was good. I like the squat dislocate with the full turn, probably one of the best we've seen. Certainly closest to handstand. Coach there just hovering under the bar. And that was just a little bit of a pause. Arm bend, use of strength. So I'll pick up the deduction. The 6-1 in qualification. Interesting to see if he's just added a little bit for the final, as we've seen with some of these gymnasts.
How do you like this? Dave Chudy's gymnastics hero is the next competitor.
He's a hugely experienced gymnast, and he's twice been part of the Chinese team, 2014, 2018, with success, but less so on an individual level. Sam Mikulak still in the silver medal position.
You've said that before.
This. I feel like I've said it many times, these championships.
I think for me that routine probably slots in just behind Servic.
Well, there you go, fifth. So Deng Shudi, 6.4, had plenty of difficulty, but we're down on the execution. That he scored the mark out of 10. Two gymnasts to come. Kohai Uchimura, King Kohai as he's been known, 10 times a world champion, 3 times European champion, and he was top of the world gold on this apparatus in 2015, but has struggled with ankle injury, so he hasn't been that dominant all-around gymnast in these championships. He's limited his work, but has made it here to the high bar final.
Yep, and you can't count him out. Top in qualification, he's got a big routine. Look at the height there, the layout position in the Kovacs. Another one's on its way. Full twist in the straight position. And again, in the tuck. Three huge releases. Good control there. Squat full. Change grasp into the straight, Markelov. Squat half turn. Hop full. Big dismount to come. Winds up. Double twist in, double back. Well, it might be his only apparatus final in this World Championships, but he certainly knows how to put on a performance.
Just the sort of class routine that we've expected over the years from Kohai Uchimura. And he's all around dominant, and he is a living legend. We're fortunate enough that at the moment we have Simone Biles on the women's side. For so many years we've been watching Uchimura, who won every all-around global title between 2009 and 2016, World and Olympics. And it's only injuries which have caused him to take a bit of a step back, but yeah, he still brings it to the party.
He does, and I think that was definitely the usual Kohai Uchimura that we're used to seeing, the clean executions, the beautiful lines, the consistency. And he's had a relatively quiet championships, I guess, in comparison to previous world championships for himself. But I think that's going to go into the medals. I think there wasn't really too much to give away to the judges. It was very clean. This is one of his squat elements here. That's into the squat half, into the handstand position. This goes just a little late past the handstand, but then finished beautifully with this double twist in double straight. And in typical Kohai fashion, sticks the landing and rounds out his championships.
So with one last routine to come, let's see how the judges score this performance.
Well, it's fabulous seeing Kohai Uchimura still performing on the world stage like this, even if it's not in the all-around stakes. How's he gonna do? He's into the silver medal position. He bumps down Sam Mikulak. Uchimura's still got it. Ankle injuries or no ankle injuries, he's going to have a medal in high bar. And he won Gymnasticum. Uchimura, what a king.
Absolutely, and a fair result that. Epke definitely put on the best show so far.
Yeah, a deserved leader. With just Arta Dalaloin of Russia to come. Epke Zonderland leading the way from Uchimura and Sam Mikulak sitting in bronze. Now Dalaloin, can he get up there and beat him once more? Parallel bars, he was the last gymnast to go. And he pushed Mikulak out of the medals. Are we gonna see it repeated here? This man already has 2 golds, 2 silvers and 1 bronze in these World Championships. This his bid for a 6th medal in these champs.
Well, whatever the outcome of this routine, certainly has been the star of the championships on the men's side. beautiful layout, Kovacs, to start. And again, in the tuck position. Straight catch, Ev. And it done a straight catch, Ev, again, which you can't repeat the same skill, so I think he was going for a half turn. Something was not right then.
Well, we've seen everybody go clean. The first fall comes at the last gymnast. Zonderland knows he's the champion.
And Mikulak.
He's going to have a medal.
He's going to have a medal. So back onto the apparatus for Dalaloyan. Squat dislocate with the half turn, straight into the handstand, no problem there. Squat dislocate into the inverted swing, high in the straight, Markelov. Well, it might not be the way he wanted to end the competition, but what a world championships this young man has had. Arthur Dalaloyan finishes the high bar final.
Oh, Zonderland can afford a smile now. And Dalaloyan, well, he's put every ounce of himself into these world championships. But you're looking at the world champion for a third time, Epke Zonderland. With the fall, the score won't challenge, but Dalaloyan, those two golds, two silvers and a bronze. You're right, Craig, he has been really the story of the championships on the men's side in terms of his achievements.
And he really is a complete gymnast, the height he can generate from the bar. If anything, the judges might deduct for being a little bit close on the catch, having to bend his arms in those Kovacs. Now, this is interesting for this because he did a straight catch, Ev, at the start. And then there's no point doing another straight catch, Ev, because that's repetition, don't get anything for it. And he does another straight catch, Ev. So whether he had a loss of concentration or he should have done that with a half turn, but very unusual and very out of character. But I don't think he'll be too disappointed. He'll be going back home with plenty of bling.
And knowledge of what he can yet achieve in the future. As I mentioned earlier, his sort of turbulent time with Russian gymnastics and a battle almost within himself to find the discipline required for gymnastics. 12.666, he'll prop up the leaderboard in this world final. But Epke Zonderland, a third world title on high bar. No other gymnast has ever had three world titles on this piece of apparatus. World champion in 2013, 14, and now again in 2018. He adds it to the Olympic title in 2012. The Flying Dutchman is soaring again, showing it to the photographers. But that man behind him, three cheers for Sam Mikulak. He finally gets a major medal on a global stage. It'll be a bronze for Mikulak. Dalaloyan couldn't bump him out of contention this time. But Epke Zonderland, I mean, Craig, he's just a spectacular gymnast. He takes the gold from Uchimura with silver. And Sam Mikulak finally gets such a well-deserved bronze. But what can we say about Zonderland?
Well, he's done it again. He's waited 4 years to get another world title. But what a final day of gymnastics. We've had so many medals shared between so many nations. It's just great to see gymnastics progressing in the right direction.
It's been a spectacular final to finish. Tremendous to see Mikulak get that medal. But all round, the Aspire Dome has seen many, many great feats over the last week, and we've loved talking about them in the commentary box here, that's for sure. But it's a, what a way to finish, seeing Epke Zonderland with a third world title on high bar.
Oh, he's such a popular winner, isn't he? And eight men had previously won two high bar world titles, but Epke is ahead of them all. And as Craig was saying, and indeed Alison, he's had a four-year wait to get that third one. And he's getting on a bit now, but you were saying, actually, the two of you, that you've seldom seen him perform some of those skills in that routine as best that he did today.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, I honestly think he makes that decision there and then on the routine, depending on how he catches the routine, depending how he catches the skill, which within itself is absolutely incredible to make such big decisions in such a short amount of time. But he's just, I guess, all the consistency over the years that he's had. I've practiced them in different combinations. That was the first one. Very, very difficult. And then he connects these two again. There's the Coleman into the Gaylord over the top of the bar. Very, very difficult work there. And sometimes, depending on who catches, he might connect, sometimes he doesn't. And I guess it's nice for him to have that choice to be able to do that and then, obviously, to come away successful today and become world champion again.
Is it my imagination, or is he just more dynamic? He seems to generate more speed throughout the routine than anybody else. He seems to have that flow right through it there.
He does, and I think Christian spoke about it. He is the cleanest that I've ever seen him perform that routine. Sometimes he puts all of these combinations together, but you can see his legs coming apart here and there. But today is the best I've seen him perform it, and the dynamic and the amplitude that he's getting is fab.
It's a great way to end any world championship, and I'm sure, actually, that medal is for little baby Bert, who was born only a fortnight ago. So congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Zonderland. Epke's coming home to do night shifts with a wee fella, I'm sure, and probably to stare at the medal as well as the baby. Fantastic. So a quick word on Sam Michalak. I think we were all saying, hooray, he's got one at last. And I thought it was going to be pipped once again, but he's worked so hard. How much satisfaction do you get for a gymnast who is as popular and as talented as Sam Michalak is for America?
Well, I think you could see just as to who was rooting for Sam. We wanted him to get his medal. It's a medal that is very, very well deserved. We know over the years he's been a top gymnast, just fell short on multiple occasions. So that medal today, I think, will make up for a lot of those results. And I think from here, he can now start to push even further. I think he knows all-round-wise, he's got the potential to be up there in the medals. High bar, we've just seen. And then also on the other apparatus, like floor, he can really, really push some of these top guys. So hopefully, it'll just be that little bit of bridging the gap that he needed for his confidence just to take him to the next level.
Hear, hear. And so say all of us, Beth, yeah?
Yeah, definitely. I was so pleased for him. He just seems to have fallen short so many times, not only this championships, but previous ones as well. So he can go home definitely a happy person.
Well, it's not the only American who's going to go home happy in the team, clearly, because they're a superstar. Simone Biles, it's 6 out of 6 in terms of medals. It's not been done for a generation by any gymnast at a World Championships or indeed an Olympic Games. And she goes home with 4 gold, 1 silver and 1 bronze. 14 world titles in total and 20 world medals. Shall we hear from Simone? David McDade has managed to catch up with her.
Well, Simone, what a week. 4 golds, 1 silver, 1 bronze. Just sum it up for us.
Yes. It's been an amazing week, especially being back out there on the big stage again. It's been a really long time since I've been to such a big competition, so I'm really proud of myself and I'm excited to go back home.
You know, you go out there and you make it look so easy, but as you mentioned, you've not really been in training for a full year yet. Just tell us what's gone into this event.
Yes, it's been a lot of hard work, especially those times in the gym you really have to gear down and put up with it and do those routines and hit those sets. So I'm really proud of the work that I put in this World Championships and hopefully to improve for the next year.
We mentioned all the medals you've won, all the records. I'll leave that for other people to talk about. But, you know, I think you've had some criticism, haven't you, online? What has it been like when people describe some of your performances as disappointing?
Yeah. I think it's pretty hard just because I didn't get to set my expectations for myself. They set them for me, and I don't think that's completely right. I think you need to hear it from the source first, and so if I would have said that, I would have been like, you know what, sorry, I disappointed you guys, but people, it's kind of rude for people to say they're disappointed in me when those weren't my expectations, so.
But compared with your own expectations, how's it gone?
Yes, it's gone really good. I've exceeded my own expectations because I didn't know what to expect coming into this world. You know, I just wanted to contribute to the team as best as possible.
Very last question, Simone. 12 routines. You know, your body must be sore. You've got a kidney stone to deal with. What's next for you?
My body is definitely screaming at me right now, but we have the banquet tonight. I have a little bit of fun, interact with the gymnast here, and then go home, rest, and then gear back up.
Listen, enjoy the party. You certainly deserve it. Thank you.
Thank you.
She sure does, and isn't it extraordinary, because she's actually tweeted, just saying, I get to decide what is a disappointing performance, not y'all. Over a year out of the sport, barely back a year, and in my first big competition, I am proud of myself. Well, the fact that she's even having to defend herself is extraordinary, because let's just show you what this lady has achieved in, well, since 2013 in the World Championships, and obviously in Olympic Games as well, where she took four gold and won bronze there. But this is the measure of this woman. 20 medals, 14 world titles in total, and she's completely dominated this. What more do people want, you gotta ask, Beth?
I don't know, because, I mean, like she says, actually, it's her own expectations that she's living up to. She shouldn't have to be defending it. I mean, yes, we are so used to her winning gold medals, but actually, for her to win six medals on all the different apparatus, the team, the all-around, is just insane. It's not been done for, I can't remember how many years.
30 years.
And the fact that she's had so long out the sport is, yeah, no, she should definitely be proud of herself. And like she says, previously, bars was her weakest piece, and she's still taken home a medal on that.
Silver as well.
Yeah, no, she 100% should be proud of herself.
And what do you think she can yet do for gymnastics, particularly at a scandal-ridden time in US gymnastics? She herself was a victim of that scandal, clearly. And with conversations about coaching cultures going on around young people, she is a role model in so many respects here.
She is, and she uses that role model status to kind of make an influence, and I think that's great, whether it's inspiring young children. She feels that responsibility to younger members to help them speak out and be brave.
OK, well, she's brave and she's back, and we'll be seeing her up to Tokyo 2020, and I wonder what she can achieve there after four golds and a bronze in Rio. We shall see. But we always unearth new talent at our World Championships, and we have again today, and even this afternoon we had a 16-year-old, Anna Padarariu, of silver, with silver on the beam for Canada, in a breakout year, actually. It's her first year as a senior, and she is taking that silver medal home. Let's hear her thoughts on that with David.
Well, Anna, that's a very, very big smile you've got on your face. Can you quite believe you've got a world silver medal around your neck?
No, but, like, I kind of can as well. Like, I don't know, it's a mix of emotions, but, like, it's so amazing being able to compete with the best gymnasts in the world and being one of them. Just unbelievable.
You mentioned some of the best in the world there, Simone Biles, Sanna Vavers, Nina Derwal, your own Ellie Black. But you've beaten almost all of them, and it was a very odd final to watch. What was it like being part of?
Once again, it was unbelievable. Like, this week has been full of ups and downs, but I was able to pull it off with lots of training, and my coaches were always there with me to lift me up and help me stay positive, and that really paid off in the end.
When you're watching some of the big names fall off and you're up fifth, what's going through your mind when you step up to the beam?
I really wasn't focusing on other people's performances leading up to mine. I was just focusing on my corrections and what I had to do to be happy.
What do you do from now? I mean, you've got this world silver medal. I guess there's going to be a big party with Team Canada tonight.
Yeah, and like Shaolin won his silver medal, which is amazing as well, because she totally deserves it. And just need to go back home and keep on working hard to maintain such a high, like, yeah.
Anna, many congratulations. Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.
And when it came to the teenagers winning medals, we've had a few surprises along the way as well. We had Carlos Yulo on floor with a medal there, and he was the youngest of all 292 male competitors. And I guess there's been so many great gymnasts that we've unearthed here from 17 different nations. Carlos was the first person from the Philippines to get a medal. But what does it say about the strength and the breadth of gymnastics globally now, and how that code of points has enabled that to happen, Beth?
Yeah, and I think it is good for our sport that it's just not dominated by a few countries. The fact that there is that widespread of medals, and I think it started a few years ago. You started to see lots of different countries coming through, and it kind of maybe inspired those other countries to think, do you know what, this is how I could possibly go forward, just specialising into one or two apparatus.
And it's also made room for the older generations as well. We saw Oksana Chusovitina take fourth place in the women's vault, Christian, at the age of 43. There's still time for you.
I mean, that's one way to look at it. To be honest, I quite like sitting here instead. I mean, she's phenomenal. It really is too. I guess just have that motivation to keep going as well, more than anything. I think that's kind of one of the hardest things when you're competing as an elite sports person, to go in the gym day in, day out, to push yourself to the boundaries, knowing that sport is tough, emotionally, physically, and she seems to be keep doing it. And then seeing the likes of Zonda Lancer up there, Risi Guang on vault winning his world championship medal. So it really is great to see that the sport is now catering for absolutely everyone. It's not just a young person sport now. It is across the spectrum, and equally they're sharing out the medals as well.
Absolutely. From 16-year-olds to 43-year-olds. We've seen it all as champions, haven't we? And in terms of Britain's involvement here, clearly Max is a standard bearer. Max Whitlock taking that silver medal on the pommel horse. OK, wasn't the colour that he wanted. He was going for a third gold medal in a row at the World Championships. But as we said before, he still proved to himself he's very much part of the conversation going forward to Tokyo.
100%. I mean, I think once he has time to reflect after the year that he's had, he'll be pleased to walk away with a silver medal. And it was so close to have it. Obviously be put into the silver medal due to the tiebreak rule. So actually his score was up there. It was just he went for a more difficult routine. But he has spoken about it earlier in the year about the difficulty he's been put in now because he needs time to be able to consolidate that routine. So, yeah, great way to go into 2019 for him.
Christian, do you think he may reconsider the all-around at some point? Because he was, well, there was a few hankering moments, he said, when he was competing in the team qualification.
I mean, you'd have to ask him that. I don't want to put any words in his mouth, but I wouldn't have thought so. I think when we put the result of this championship into context, he's still the second best person in the world on the pommel horse this year. That's incredible. There's no other way of looking at it. And I think we know he can do a more difficult routine. We know he can make the routine more cleaner, execution-wise. So, I don't see any negatives from these championships for him, really. I think it's a big step moving forward. I think that it's going to be very much a watch this space leading to 2019 and then Tokyo 2020.
And, of course, for the British men, finishing fifth in the team competition, and we saw Dom Cunningham just a fraction outside at the medal podium in the vault today. Confidence levels for you, Beth, in the men's team at the moment, then?
Yeah, I think huge confidence. I mean, obviously, they're still producing amazing results. They've still got time. We've had injuries. And obviously, with Dominic still sort of breaking into the scene on his first year, European champion, Commonwealth medalist, and then also a world finalist and finishing fourth.
We know, of course, that the British women didn't make the team final this time. That was disappointing. It was about a tenth of a mark that they didn't get in there. But there's no panic where you're concerned. How do you view that? How do you view their performance overall?
Yes, they didn't qualify for the team final, and obviously they will be hugely disappointed with that. But actually, when we looked at the results, it was 0.1 away. So it's a step here or there. And when we looked at the results between the rest of the teams, it was fractional between all of those top teams. So on a different day, they probably would have qualified. So I'm not worried at all. And obviously, they'll come back. They know what they've got to work on, working on that execution leading into the 2019 season. And obviously, hopefully, having Claudia Fragapani and Amy Tinkler back in the team as well.
OK. Well, we shall watch the space where both teams are concerned. These 6 days, I have to say, have felt like a bit like a busman's holiday for all of us. It's been absolutely brilliant to watch it, and I hope you've enjoyed it as well. But there's so much sport on BBC Sport to enjoy, and here's where to find it.
More of the sport you expect. Plus, another 1,000 hours of the sport you might not. Now available online, on our app, and on your connected TV. Prepare to be moved.
And if you are a gymnastics fan, there is another added bonus with coverage of the World Trampolining and Tumbling Championships from St. Petersburg from November the 8th. That's this coming Thursday. Rio Olympic silver medalist Bryony Page and two-time world champion Kat Driscoll are both part of the GB team, so all of that should keep a little spring in your step. But it's time for us to handspring our way home. Well, these two will probably do it. I shall just probably walk. My thanks to all of the team here. Thanks for being with us. It's been the biggest world gymnastics competition in history. But there's only one Simone Biles who rules the roost at the end of it. Bye-bye for now.
Gold for Biles for a world record fourth time in the women's all-around.
Absolutely phenomenal.
Simone Biles, yet another world gold medal. There is a new world champion and no third successive world gold for Max Whitlock. It's another gold for Simone Biles. She confirms her status as just the best gymnast the world has seen.